What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 36 of the Hive Mind Podcast. We're on YouTube, SoundCloud, iTunes, Google Play. Check us out wherever you want to watch us. Sorry about this show being a little earlier than I expected. Nope. I thought I was going to be later than I was. I was at a wedding, so got another one to go to next weekend.
Yeah, yours?
No, dude, fuck that.
No? Or whose wedding is it?
One of my friends. He actually listens to this sometimes. So,
really,
yeah,
nice. Is it like a high flying deal or like a low key thing?
I think it's pretty low key. That's my interpretation. It's pretty. It's like a casual thing. Like the dress attire is casual, so that makes me think it's pretty low key. But I don't know. Like, if it's gonna be some big fucking.
Are you in it?
No.
So you're going in like fucking t-shirt and like fucking workout shorts?
No. No, I'm going to wear what I wear to work, which is like a polo and khakis, which is what I wore to this thing.
I have to wear like nice shit where like I work, but like sometimes I don't. And I'm not up on like the business fucking dress lingo. Like we had this one meeting and our like director was like, the dress code is, what do you say, summer casual or something? And I'm like, I don't even know what the fuck that means. Like, is it
summer
casual,
I would imagine, is a polo and like khaki shorts.
Yeah, well, right. That's basically what it is. But I didn't. I don't think I even own a pair of khaki shorts lately. I used to, but anyway. So I was finally like, fuck that. I'm tired of going in like my actual work attire, which is like long black pants and a polo, when I can just wear shorts. Shorts and flip flops to the meeting, but. Yeah, it's cool. Yeah, our wedding was like super low key too. Like, I wanted to do any like big deal. But is there a like a bachelor party or something you get to go to?
I don't think so. No, I wasn't invited if there was, but it doesn't seem like the bachelor party type.
Right. They're having like fucking Popeye's chicken cater it.
I don't know. I don't know anything about it other than it's next weekend and it's at this place that I'm gonna have to use my GPS to get to because I have no idea where it is.
Nice. I looked up your ye old family car dynasty online. I don't know why I did that, but I was looking up something, and I was like, I wonder if I could look up his fucking car dealership and see what it's about. And
a lot of that stuff is probably old, because they just redid the building, so like if you were like Google and mapping it, that stuff's probably pretty old.
Right. No, this is pretty much to see the reviews. And he had like one review. It was pretty good, though. So,
yeah, we have a bunch of reviews on Facebook, but like Google or whatever, like we don't have any. But yeah, our whole shtick is return customers, so we're pretty highly reviewed.
Right. Yep. So yeah, I don't know, man. It hasn't been that crazy of a week for me. How do you think Hotted?
I wanted to talk about that a little bit. Yeah, the last show was a little awkward because I like Hotted obviously cares about his like reputation a little bit, so I didn't want to like sling too much fucking mud, but I'm totally down to sling some mud today. Like some of the people I wanted to talk about, he's friends with, like you know that Phantom Lord guy.
No, who's that?
Oh shit,
Phantom Lord.
Yeah, so Phantom Lord is a big Twitch streamer, like huge, like 20,000 viewers, huge. And you know the whole CSGO gambling website thing? Right. Like all that drama? Turns out he owned one too, right? And he was doing all the shitty stuff that T. Martin and those other guys were doing, right? Didn't disclose that he owned it, promoted it, broke tons of FTC guidelines, whatever. Not that bad, in my opinion. Bad, but not that bad. Well, it turns out he was actually rigging the games too. Like, oh, confirmed rigging the games and stealing money from his moderators in his chat, his viewers, everybody. Good. Like, this guy could legit get jail time. Like, this guy could legit go away. Like, he really fucked up.
Right. I mean, they're not.
And he got banned from Twitch permanently. He's gonna be in some serious legal trouble for sure over this. Like, I don't think T. Martin and those guys, like, people are saying, like, oh, they're gonna get time. Like, I don't think they will. They'll probably get away with it. But this dude, he's fucked.
Right. Yeah, as he should be, though.
Yeah, I mean, oh yeah, no, fuck him.
Because it's, like, real money. Yeah, I would probably do shit like that when I was, if I was like a lot younger.
The most damning thing is that the people, like, he wasn't just stealing money from his viewers, he was stealing money from his moderators and like his top donators, because like his top donators or whatever would be like, hey man, let's play a game, like let's gamble against each other just for fun, right? And he'd be like, yeah, sure. And he, meanwhile, he'd fucking rig it to where he'd win. Like, he was stealing. It wasn't like he was just stealing money from random people. He was stealing money from his, like, most loyal fans.
Well, I mean, if you're going to steal, though, I must do it from the people that would never see it coming. You know what I mean?
Unreal. Like, the only reason that people found out about this is because a hacker hacked his Skype, and he had all this shit logged in Skype.
What did he have logged? A conversation?
All the conversations, like, with the other guy that ran the website. He's like, hey, getting ready to gamble. Can you rig it for me?
Wow.
Yeah, dude, it's really bad.
Wow. I don't know. Well, yeah, I think I've heard of that guy before. Like, the only really, like, the big...
His Twitter, like, he hasn't said a word since the whole thing broke. Like, like,
what can you say?
Well, the reason... Yeah, he knows he's fucked. Like T. Martin, like, he's just going to be in some YouTube drama for a while. I honestly don't think this will even kill T. Martin. And those other guys, like T. Martin and Syndicate, those guys, this thing will blow over for them. Like, people don't care. Like, what they were doing was shitty because it was like, hey, look, that's kind of shitty, you own the website and you're lying to people that you don't own the website. But they weren't actively rigging the thing that we know of. Like, it was favored by them, and yes, even if they lost, they still won because they were making money off the transactions off the gambling website. But that's way different than rigging it.
Right. I always wondered,
I love,
like,
it, dude. It's so funny to me.
I always wondered about, like, those online poker sites back when they were bigger, or because...
Yeah, but when they first came out, they were rigged.
Right, but you didn't... I don't think a lot of the owners of that shit were, like, the actual players. Like, I mean, I may be wrong, but, like, you know how Negreanu owns one, and then, like, all of them, like, have kind of bought those websites. I think back then it was just, like, the websites. But I don't know if I ever heard of one confirmed, but I did hear somebody...
Well, they got regulated a lot. They're right. Way less awesome than they used to be, too.
I heard of somebody getting five queens once on one of those, but I did not I did not see that happening.
That's fucking next level.
I can't confirm. Can't confirm that happened, but I would not be surprised. The only CSGO streamer that I really know of too much is what's his nuts? Summit.
Yeah, I don't watch CSGO that much, but I love this shit. This shit's hilarious to me.
Yeah. Well, you just want to see people get fucked online.
Like, it's not that I want to see it, but when it happens, I love seeing it. It's not like I'm sitting here like waiting for the next big like drama alert fucking thing to happen, but when it happens, I like to see it.
Well, I just want to know, like, who's playing that shit? Like, I guess a lot of people are, but I just wonder what they're...
I think a lot of it's just kids, man. Like, I think this goes back to, like, anytime that, like, there's something that's massively popular and neither of us do it, we're just not the demographic. We're not the audience.
Right, but if you listen to our fucking comments on the podcast, that includes anything about politics or Europe. Like, every time we comment on that shit,
the Europe, like, thing is crazy, because I have a lot of people that are from, you know, these European countries that are like, yes, this is what's happening. Like, I'm glad that somebody is saying it.
What? Oh, you're talking about the shootings and shit. I'm talking about like the Brexit thing when we commented on that, and then you had.
Oh,
like,
yeah, no, I wasn't that, like, knowledgeable about that.
European,
to be honest,
listeners are like, fucking, it's hilarious seeing you guys, blah, 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 talk about...
Well, I don't think we said anything that... What did we say that was bad? Like, we kind of skirted around it. We both kind of said we didn't know much about it.
Quote-unquote uneducated, I guess. I don't know. I mean, I guess, coming from an American, I guess I don't really care that much.
Yeah, dude, our stock market recovered. Who gives a fuck about those faggots?
Right. But the shooting thing's pretty crazy, man. That had that Munich mall shooting, which, yep, I'm pretty sure was confirmed to be a Muslim.
So, he was a Muslim, but apparently he was not a terrorist. But he was a Muslim.
Right. I'm pretty sure, like,
Well, the reports, I actually just read up on this before we started. Apparently he was obsessed with mass shootings, but good. He was in fact a Muslim. Like, he had all these, like, books about, like, shooters and killers and shit in his room, apparently. So, who knows if he was inspired by that, but, yeah.
What was I going to say? Oh, speaking of mass killers, did you hear about this shit with Blizzard and this Heroes of the Storm kid?
No.
You didn't hear about this? So, this kid, he was a Heroes of the Storm player, got silenced by, you know, on this new fucking silence thing.
Yep.
But he was, like, legit, like, being ridiculous. Like, talking about how he's going to, like, rape people and blah, blah, blah. Anyway, so, like, Blizzard silences him. And I might tell, like, one or two facts of this thing wrong, but I'm pretty sure a majority of this is right. And so then he starts sending, like, emails or messages to, like, Blizzard and Blizzard employees saying, like, you better fix this shit or I'm going to show up to Blizzard headquarters with an AK and some other toys. Like, legit, like, threatening, like, them. They fucking turned it over to the FBI, and they arrested this kid. And he's going to get, like, no shit, like, up maybe up to 5 years. Well, he's not going to get 5 years, but that's the max penalty.
How old is he?
He is, I think he's 26.
Oh, what? Oh, my God. That's embarrassing.
Hang on. Blizzard.
I thought you were going to say he's like 14. Like, I thought it was going to be an actual kid, not somebody that's fucking considerably older than me.
Here. Bam.
Is there a picture of this fucking little retard?
Steven Cebula, 28.
That is so fucking embarrassing.
Sacramento gamer. You keep silencing me in Heroes, and I may or may not pay you a visit with an AK-47. Careful, Blizzard. I live in California. Apparently, he admitted that he had sexual fantasies about, like, his 5-year-old fucking cousin or something. Like, there's all kinds of shit with this dude that's, like, all fucked up, but I can't believe you didn't hear about that. I think that's, like, one of the first things with Blizzard where they actually, like, turned your ass over to, like, the fucking FBI who then arrested you.
One of my, there's a guy that used to be part of the Dara McTyre, like, video editing crew. His name was Preposterous. He did the, and you won't know what this is, but he did the Arena Master series back in the day. He was the voice of that, if anyone remembers that that's listening to this. Turns out that dude is a rapist. Like, he's in jail. Yeah.
You mean, like, in video games?
No, in real life.
Oh, with his actual penis.
Yeah.
Not his e-penis. Right. Well, you heard about that guy Roe, right? Like, he's like that, he was a WoW podcaster, community person, on Twitter, but apparently, like, somebody hacked him or somebody did something and found out about, like, his real name and his past, and apparently, like, he's a registered, like, sex offender. And, like, I guess people cared about it on the internet. I don't know why they would, really. I mean, if you're not, like, whatever, but, like,
I have seen some cases of people being on that fucking list that shouldn't be, though, so.
What, the registered sex offender list?
Yeah, I feel like they need to describe what you did in fucking detail on that list. Like, if they're going to put you on the list, describe in detail what happened. So not, like, was 19, hooked up with a 16-year-old slut who lied. Like, that should be the fucking description if you're going to get bullshitted on that list.
Yeah. Well, in that guy's case, he claimed, you know, whatever, but, so you're saying, like, the fucking list, you get, like, you know, where it's, like, your name, then you get, like, your fucking guild tag. That's, like, what you did.
Yeah. Because, like, dude, there's people that are on that shit for, like, bullshit reasons. Like, there's people on there that, like, raped children, and then there's people on there that hooked up with the fucking wrong girl who lied. And her dad was the wrong person.
Right.
So.
Yeah, that shit's crazy, like, how you can, as a woman, you can just kind of, like, fuck a guy's life forever if you want to.
It's fucking great.
It's bullshit, dude. Like, if you get caught doing that shit, you should get, like, 3 times the sentence that whoever you fucked over got. Like, that shit is just, I mean. And the other thing I was thinking about. So you heard about this shooting in Miami where they shot this black caregiver with it was sitting next to their retarded kid. You heard it though about Robert,
yes.
Right? So this cop shot this unarmed black guy who was laying on the ground with his arms up.
It's fucking comical.
Saying please, you know, please don't shoot me. Shoots him, and then they did the investigation, and what they came back with was, I was aiming at the retarded kid, not the black guy. I just missed.
Dude, no. The best part is when they interviewed the black guy that got shot. He's like, so I got shot in the leg, and it felt like a mosquito bite. And I turned around and asked the cop, why did you shoot me, sir? And he said, goes, I don't know. What a fucking joke, dude.
Yeah. Well, so my point was, though, that, like, and you know, that one got called in basically from, like, you know, there's a guy with a gun, blah, blah, blah. Like, I guess that's the new thing is you can get a black guy killed if you just call in and he's got a gun.
The funniest part is that I think the call was because of the autistic guy that was, like, they said he was trying to kill himself. So right. The police go to try and stop somebody from killing themselves by shooting them.
Yeah, that's, I mean, that dude, whole, like, that was the thing that I thought was fucking comical was, like, it's not a race issue, I didn't mean to shoot the black guy, I was aiming at the retarded kid with the toy truck, and I missed. Like, there's so much wrong with that, like, number one.
Yeah, that was awful.
You can't hit a guy from, like, 30 yards, you miss, like, by a whole body length, you don't deserve to be a fucking cop. And,
dude, the fucked up thing is, like, for whatever reason, like, the Black Lives Matter people, everybody they choose to represent is horrible. Like, they're fucking horrible people. But, like, this guy, they probably won't give a shit.
Oh, right, because he's, like, a college-educated...
Yeah, it's just, like, where... Like, these are the people...
Did,
like,
you see it? Did you see, like, what... It was on social media, though. They were like, can't wait to see what they pull out for this guy. He got a D in math in, like, third grade. And that's what they're going to use to say he was a piece of shit. Yeah. You see that? That, like, was on...
Like, typically I stand up for the cops in a lot of these situations, but, I mean, obviously that one is fucking ridiculous.
Right. But you know, with that fucking... I was aiming at the other guy who I blah, 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 toy truck. You know they're going to be like, well, I mean, we could see that. And then this guy's not...
Now, that black dude that got shot is going to get a payday. Fucking massive payday.
As he should.
And I bet he's so fucking happy he got shot. I know I'd be. Fucking A, dude.
Really?
He got shot in the leg in, like, an inconsequential spot, and he's going to get a fucking massive payday, like a monster payday.
Would you get shot in the dick for $1 billion? No. With a 9mm?
Not in the dick.
22.
I'm not going to get shot in the dick for $1 billion.
Really?
Yeah. No, I want to keep my dick, dude.
BB gun.
Yeah. Dude, of course.
Really? You know, you could penetrate a testicle if you pump a BB gun enough times.
Yeah, but you're not gonna, like, dude, you're not gonna lose your dick. It's just gonna be fucking...
I don't think, like, you'd lose your dick from a 22 either. I don't know. $1 billion? I'm pretty sure with $1 billion you could buy a new dick. You could, like, one of these...
I want to be able to enjoy the $1 billion.
You could pay off a cop to make a black guy disappear and you'd wind up with, like, a black dick. Like, that's what would happen. You could get, like, a 12-inch fucking dick if you had $1 billion. I'd cut a deal with somebody. There was somebody had a good fucking... What was it? A good... On the last podcast comments, there was a good question that I was going to address, but I don't remember what it was. It was something about, like, that if-then thing. But yeah, man, the fucking week's been crazy. And then there's that DNC
such,
fucking
dude, this
shit.
Week is such a shit show. I love it.
Did you see that they fired... what's her nuts?
They did Schultz. Finally the DNC chairwoman or whatever.
Yep, she's gone.
That must be new as of, like,
this afternoon.
Now, yeah, because I was watching the news and people were saying, like, this is fucking ridiculous that they haven't fired her yet.
Like, did you read some of the things from those emails?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not surprised by it, but it is kind of funny that it's actually, like, officially happening.
Her super PAC was paying, like, young people to push back against Sanders supporters on social media.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And she wanted to appeal to more Republicans, but she has to kind of fake like she's more of a liberal just to get the Bernie Sanders vote. It's like, Jesus Christ. Like, do you have any actual beliefs of your own, or are you just really going to, say anything to get elected? Like, I don't know, man. Like, I don't think I could, like... Not the biggest Trump fan, but I don't think I could ever vote for Hillary Clinton.
Yeah, that's kind of where I'm at. So, like, she is actually, like, one of the fucking worst people ever.
Yeah, she's actually just like a bad human being. Like, there are other people that are like make dumb decisions or whatever that aren't actually like shitbag human beings. She's just like a bad.
Like, the thing with Donald Trump is like he's a shitbag person, but he's like very openly a shitbag person. Like, right. He's not like,
you know what you're
like,
getting.
You know exactly what you're gonna get. Like, you're gonna get this like egotistical. What's the word? Tacky. Like, you're gonna get this tacky, egotistical guy that puts like gold on everything.
Cringe
but
fest.
But you know what you're getting with Hillary Clinton. Like, what the fuck? Like, everything about her is just so scary and cunty.
Right, and fucking backdoor and all kinds
of.
Yeah. Like, yeah, I'm with you. I don't know, man, but do you see fucking your boy Gary Johnson's got like almost 14% now, and he needs like one more percent to actually get on the debate stage? I bet he'll get it. I bet he's actually going to be up there too, which is pretty good, right? Because like, even though he's not going to win, like by any means he's not going to win, just being on the
debate stage. Wouldn't that be some crazy shit, though? If like there was like this monster turnaround or something, it won't happen. But
no, but I do think though that if people would actually listen to somebody like, you know what I mean, one of those viewpoints, they might be like, man, that guy makes a lot of fucking sense. Like, I don't know, maybe I am this weird third party shit that I never thought I could be, because so many people just think like I'm either a Democrat or
Republican. So many people only know there's two choices.
So, like, if you know, when he gets up there and he actually has some pretty valid points, people, you know, he might sway some people. I don't know. But at least he would, you know, make sure, like, in the next election that it was a little more fair. They also, too, I don't know if you saw that, but they're revising the role of superdelegates. Like, I guess Sanders got that through, too, where so, like, they're basically, I think the gist of it is, instead of these individual, unbound, unpledged delegates to kind of vote however they want, they're forming like a council that's going to, I guess, serve a lot of the same purpose, but be about a third the size. And the council is going to decide sort of together, I guess, who they back. I think that's how it goes. But so that's getting revised too.
Yeah, that's one of those things where it's like, I'll see it. I'll believe it when I see it kind of deal, like if it actually is more fair or not, because it's far away. It's not happening this cycle, clearly.
Right. Yeah, so. No, definitely not. Did you watch the Republican convention?
I watched some of it. Like, I think I watched like 15 minutes of Donald Trump's speech, like expecting it to end sometime soon, and apparently it went on for like an hour and a half.
Yeah. Did you see Giuliani, though? Giuliani was like on fucking crack. You see,
yeah, I was listening to a podcast and they played a soundbite of it where he's like, the police, they come, like, they come, yeah, or whatever. Yeah. So, like, yeah, he had like a fucking Braveheart speech.
Right.
They don't care if you're black, white, or Mexican, they come.
My favorite was they had this guy singing these songs, and you know that song, like, So Happy Together? You know what I'm talking about, right? Like, I don't really want to sing it, but.
Yeah, just give me the...
Me
you, the...
something and something, so happy together, you know what I'm
talking
Oh,
about? That one, yeah.
So, this guy doesn't know the fucking lyrics, apparently, and he's singing at the convention, so whenever he didn't know the lyrics, he just went, mana. So, like, where there actually were supposed to be words, it was just this guy mumbling. Like,
dude, if I was up there, I would do that. I would do that move where you put the mic, you have the mic to your mouth, you put it to the crowd. That would be my go-to move if I didn't know the lyrics.
Just Eminem style, just hold that bitch out.
I don't think he invented that, but
yeah, but well, right, but he did it at least once. Anyway, yeah, dude, that shit was fucking crazy. Like, I the polls are pretty close, apparently, so we'll see how
my favorite new thing. Did you see the thing about Barack Obama's brother?
Yeah, Malik.
He's voting for Trump.
Yeah, but apparently...
That's fucking hilarious, though.
Apparently, he's, like, not, like... Like, apparently, he's, like, three wives in, like, thinks his brother killed fucking Gaddafi.
Oh, yeah, he's
like,
probably a crazy fucking retard, but who cares?
Right.
It's still funny as fuck. Like, that was his best. That was the best man in Obama's wedding. Was that fucking guy who's voting for Trump? That's so fucking funny.
Right. Yes. That is pretty funny. Yeah. I don't know what you do, man. Like, it's...
There's a picture of him wearing a fucking Trump hat, too.
Really? I didn't see that.
Yeah, I have to find it. But, yeah, no, it's pretty amazing.
I don't know, man. They're pretty close. I wonder what the DNC thing is going to be like. Like, what I want to know is, like, why do we need... Like, when I was watching that thing, and I was thinking to myself, like, this shit is, like, reminiscent of, like, the fucking MTV, like, music awards. Like, why do we need an event like this? Where there's, like, a fucking, like, broadcaster, like, a play-by-play announcer at front, and there's, like, what is the purpose of that event? I guess just to, like...
This whole election has just been fucking hilarious with that stuff. Like, it's just been a giant, like, reality show.
Right.
The 2016 election, real world.
For sure. I think I posted this on Twitter too, but I think if anything, between like Clinton and Trump and the fucking DNC fucking leaks and all these like cop shootings and all this other bullshit, like I think if this year has taught people or should have taught people anything, it's that like it doesn't matter what you fucking hear or what video you watch on the fucking news, like that shit is like partial truth at best. Like, there's no way to tell, like, what the actual fucking real story is anymore with how the fucking media is. Because you're, I mean, like, you know, I think you said before, like, people don't want to hear some boring-ass, like, actual story news. You know what I mean? People want to hear, like, the crazy
It's going to get even more entertaining, too. Because you know that all, like, both the Hillary camp and the Trump camp, they're hanging on to their nukes. Like, both sides have fucking nuclear bombs to drop on each other. And it's only a matter of time. Like, once the election actually gets a little closer, like, the real dirty shit's gonna come out. Like, this is just a pregame. Like, it's gonna get even more fucking ridiculous.
Dude, like, you wouldn't even talk about it. The fucking Melania fucking plagiarizing, like...
That shit is funny as fuck.
Half of,
There was a Rickroll in there, too. You know that?
In where?
In the speech.
What do you mean?
In the speech that Melania Trump gave... There's literally a part where she's like, Donald Trump will never give you up or never let you down and never hurt you. Like, literally, like, the lyrics to the fucking Rick Astley song.
No.
Yes. No. I swear. Let me find... I bet there's a YouTube video of it. Let me try to find it. Go ahead.
Well, the other crazy shit was... So, apparently... And I don't know if this is true or not, but I mean, I did see this was going on Twitter, but...
Here we go. I found it. Sorry.
Wait, link it.
Hey, let's watch it together. Let me know when you're going to have it up.
All right, ready?
Yeah, 3, 2, 1, play.
He will never, ever give up. And most importantly, he will never, ever let you down.
Never going to give you up. Never going to let you down. Never
gonna
wow. That's fucking amazing, dude.
Who slipped that in there? Like, that's fucking hilarious. Do you remember back in WildStar's days when that game was around?
Yes. No, I remember it.
Do you remember the Rickroll that Bitwise, John Wiseman, put in the game?
It wasn't it if you like tried to exploit like
nope,
in
it
some
was
certain
a,
way?
It was a macro, basically. Because you use macros for a couple different things. And it was like a slash eval script. And what it was it was kind of a troll, but it was a make me level 50. Like, it was supposed to be like on the beta. So it was on the beta, and it insta-promoted you to like level 50 just so you could test out content. And when the game went live, he put that in the actual game. But instead of it actually making you level 50, it called your browser to open and take you to the fucking YouTube video.
Yeah.
Which was actually pretty fucking genius.
It's funny.
So, yeah, that was actually in that game. I played WildStar. I tell you, I probably didn't, but I tried out the Chew a Warrior, actually.
Don't they make you pay for that?
Yeah, but I had the little... I have, like, a sub to WildStar for, like, the next 3 years because I bought, like, the $5 boxes, a lot of them, a while ago. So I have the subscriber thing, so I had a shit ton of the... you can get it with the free in-game currency.
Yeah.
So that's what
I always wanted to play one.
Dude, the animations, like, I guess this must have been, like, I think they have, like, one animator on staff left That must have been what this guy's last year was, because the animations for the Chew a Warrior are fucking top notch.
Are they different than the other animations for the other warrior races? Because like that's the thing with Wildstars. Oh wow, that's actually a unique thing.
Like when he pulls out his or when he does.
I know when he pulls out the sword, he flips it in the air.
Yeah. Yep. Savage.
But is the Rampage animation different?
I think so.
Because that was the thing, like, is that all the races had the same animations. Like, they all did the, like, sword swipes the same way. They all did the savage strikes, the downward chopping motion or whatever.
Well, they still do that. So I just don't know if, like, I don't know if it's the exact same, but it looks really good. So anyway, I played, I did some PvP, because that's what I enjoy doing in that game. They've done some cool things, like, So to combat the queues, they pretty much remove the faction restrictions from PvP and from like dungeons and expeditions and stuff. And they have the contracts, right? So you can do your PvP contracts. And I guess what they did to combat like the wait was they gave you these like quests that just kind of keep populating, so you can just do them over and over again, that are world content quests. Like they send you out into like Crimson Badlands or wherever. And you do like a thing, and that thing gives you like 200 to 300 honor, like it's is it honor? No, prestige. So like, it's actually a really easy way to get currency. Like gear is not really hard to obtain for like the PvP seasons, but there's a pretty big disparity between people that have actually played the game like the whole time, and like me,
oh, yeah.
just fucking coming back. You know what I mean? Like. But it was good, man. I actually thought about doing it. I did a YouTube video yesterday, and I thought about doing another one about like people that tried WildStar like way back in the day, and like how the game is different. Because it's not a bad so it's not WoW, but like between the other MMOs that are like still surviving, like Rift and fucking Terra and Secret World and all that other shit, like it's definitely worth somebody trying. You know what I mean? Like, I think it's one of those things where, like, it's got a stigma on it that keeps people away now, which I don't necessarily think it should have. So
it's going to be hard for them to get rid of that stigma. Because so many people just sit, like, will be like, oh, a lot of people don't play this game. Next.
Right. Right. So who knows? We'll see. But, yeah, so I had a warrior. He was like he was a Makari. And I took him to the little fucking, like, barbershop place. I clicked Chua, and I like hit apply, and he just like fucking shrunk down to a Chua like immediately. I was like, I've never seen that in a game before, but okay, I guess I could just flip races every day if I wanted to. But yeah, man, that's what I did. So, yeah. What do you got?
Let me look at my topic list. I was looking at your YouTube channel.
Oh, I just did the one video from yesterday. And I used some, like, fucking Skrillex fucking Sonic thing that I had on my computer for, like, intro music. And the one dude who, like, listens to this podcast is just like, thanks for making a video that looks like it belongs in 2008. I was like, no worries, buddy. That's good music.
But, oh, this just, apparently there was a Syrian refugee that just macheted a pregnant woman in Germany.
Oh, good.
Shocker.
Good. That's what, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, we never talked about the train thing either, did we? Maybe we did.
Oh, I was going to finish telling you, but the speech thing. So apparently Trump shared an apology / resignation from the speechwriter who apparently copied that part of Michelle Obama's speech. And the name on the thing was whatever her name is, Heather, whatever the fuck it was. But anyway, it supposedly came from her, and she was a writer, and she said, I offered my resignation, and Mr. Trump declined it, saying, you know, he's an upstanding guy, I'm so proud to work for this family, blah, 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 blah. So they, the internet did some research, I guess, and that writer, her Twitter page is literally, like, has a picture of a yoga instructor from Florida. Like, apparently, like, her Twitter page is...
It's just fake?
Yeah. Or just made up. Like, it was like this whole fucking rigmarole thing that I shouldn't have.
They really need to do their homework with like Google image searching shit to make sure. Yeah.
I was thinking about that. How do you find that? Like, how would I...
How do you Google image search?
Yeah.
It's really actually pretty easy. So, go to Google. Just type some, like, search something randomly into Google. Then go to images. Mm-hmm. And you see that thing? Like, are you on just, like, any random Google image? Search result? Just anything?
Yeah, image. Yep.
Yeah, now you see that that little camera in the search box? Where you type in your... Yeah, you click on that. Then you upload an image. Or link an image, and then you search it.
Huh. How does it... That's kind of... That's
it's fucking magic. Now, there are people that are good at this. Now, this is, like, the plebeian way to do it. But there are people that, like, figure... Like, the people that, like, can identify porn stars, like crazy. Like, apparently they have, like, some more advanced method of doing this shit, where they can, like, search through videos and shit. I don't know anything about that, but... I know to do it through Google Images. Well, that's it.
Right. You know what I actually read one time, and you wouldn't think that it's as genius as it is, but have you ever looked up, and you probably don't because I don't think you're into this kind of shit, but have you ever been curious about how Shazam works?
Is that the music identifying software?
Yes. Have you ever like looked up like how it actually, because you think it wouldn't be easy, you think it would be easy, right? Because like, you know, a WAV file has like peaks and valleys in it and blah, blah, blah. And you think that all it does
I think what's more impressive is the YouTube Content ID system. That shit is fucking impressive. That's like Shazam on crack. Not only does it identify the songs, it identifies the songs and videos that people intentionally tamper with to try and make the thing not be able to identify them. The Content ID system on YouTube is fucking impressive.
Right. I'm sure they work off of... similar technologies.
Oh, I'm sure.
But it's really cool that it's able to do that with background noise. Because like if it just identified like straight up peaks and valleys, like background noise would fuck your shit up, because it you know what I mean? But like the way they do like their confidence intervals and the way they like how long they have to listen for, I don't know. There's actually like a really long paper on how it works, but
yeah, a lot of smart people, way smarter than us, made that shit.
I wish I could have, man. I had a buddy when I was in college that is on that level, and I say that not lightly. He got a 1598 on his SAT, and he was pissed off because he knew the question he missed, so he took it again and got a 1600.
Huh.
He's now it was physics at UF, but he got bored. So then he became a PhD statistician at Stanford. And this guy was, we were sitting in class one time at UF, and I was like, what are you doing? He had like six or seven paper. He's big into college football. He had like six or seven pieces of paper that he was writing shit out on. He's like, I just figured out a new college BCS ranking system that's way more accurate. I was like, okay.
I'm just fucking around.
Yeah, just fucking dicking off. Like, I'm doodling a fucking cock. You know what I mean? On my fucking paper. And he's got, like, this whole shit. So, I wish I could have, like... But he didn't have really good social skills. Like, how we became friends is actually I stole his homework. We had this, like...
Nice.
We had this inbox where you put your homework in when you got in that day. And it was, like, due that day or whatever. And, like, a lot of the shit I would just wouldn't do or whatever. Because I was, I don't know, I just playing video games or something. And so like some of this shit was hard. Like you had to like actually work out like these really long fucking things. I mean, my school wasn't easy. So I realized this kid always got like hundreds on everything. So I was like, maybe I'll just, man, that guy, he always early and he's always got everything fucking right. And so I just would take his paper out of the box and I'd like intentionally fuck up like a couple and change some of his logic on some answers. And one day he sat behind me in this auditorium and he was like, hey, he's talking to his other friend. He's like, I don't know where my homework went. I went to go change something, and it's not in there. I was like, I had it like in my desk in front of me. So I was like, I turned around and I was like, hey, so yeah, I'm Will, by the way. And I sort of have your homework, and I pretty much have it like every day. And he's like, oh, really? He's like, well, let me see it real quick. Let me change something. So we actually became pretty good friends. And but he had never good social skills. Like the deal was he would do our take-home exams, and I introduced him to his girlfriend. So we had a pretty good system. Well,
there you go. That's a win-win.
So, but that's what I never hooked on to, was somebody's fucking genius that I could exploit their God-given talent.
Yeah, my brother's like a fucking smart as fuck asshole too. He graduated with like a 4.5 or something in our school system. There aren't like the AP classes are unweighted like most of them are, so he had literally straight A's and like all of the hardest shit. He got literally a perfect fucking high school like ride. I don't know.
What is it, a 5.0 or a 4.5 is perfect? I'm trying to remember.
It depends on the school apparently. Like, so that's one of the things my brother was pissed off about, is because a lot of these schools, some of the classes are weighted to where an A can be a 5. And apparently they unweighted a lot of his stuff for whatever reason. I don't know that much about it. I'm talking out of my ass, but it depends on the school. That's the fucking thing.
I had like,
and also our school had a 7-point grade scale, which made it even harder because it meant a 93 was a B.
Yeah, so we in college, like, our shit was so hard that if they actually graded it on a actual legit 10-point scale, like, no one would ever pass. So like, we had our shit. I think it was like 70 was like a C.
God damn! That's right.
It was like
on a 10-point scale. That's,
yeah, but it was really curved. Like, you could get maybe it was like a 50, because you could get like in the 80s and still get an A, and then
some fucking curve there.
Yeah, it had to be though, because like they either made the shit really face roll, or they made the grading easier.
Dude, that's where I was at in high school. Like, I was too dumb.
Not high school.
Oh, I know, but like, this isn't really super related, but I was too dumb to be in the really smart classes. Like, I was way too fucking stupid to be in the AP classes, but I was way too smart to be in the normal classes. Like, it was either like 0 or 100 for me. Like, my freshman year of high school, I took like all the hardest shit and I was like fucking miserable. And then I said, fuck that. And I just took like normal English, normal like math, normal whatever.
Retard status.
Yeah, and it wasn't like there weren't retards in the class. It was just normal fucking people. And I just like cruised through it. Like,
right. You know, the class is going to be easy when it's called math. Like, that's literally the name of the class is math.
Math. But what's funny is that all the actual retards took all of the useful shit. Like, the personal finance class that like teaches you how to do all your taxes and shit. Like, all the retards took that. Meanwhile, all the smart people are like, what the fuck do I do?
Right. We had, I had really bad, like, when my freshman year, like, I didn't really give a fuck of high school. And I had like medium grades, and my girlfriend, who I met over that summer, was a year ahead of me, and she was the valedictorian of her class. And I remember thinking to myself, like, man, this bitch is not that smart. Like I could do this. Like, I just don't care. And I remember that she always used to like, I was really super competitive. So finally one time I was like, that summer I was like, fuck that. I was like, if she can get these fucking grades, I can get pretty decent grades. So I started just trying to do it to prove that I could get better grades in the classes that she was like always used to try to brag about. So I actually ended up getting really good grades, except that we had to do this project my sophomore year, where it was like a science thing. And I remember I just did something for it to be stupid. It was something based off like relative humidity and fucking dew point and shit like that. And instead of actually doing like I had to take readings every day, right? So I had to go outside with a fucking thermometer and like read shit. But I wasn't going to do that. I was too lazy to do that. So instead of getting like the barometric pressure and all that other shit, I just looked on the fucking the news and just wrote down whatever it said. And then, so I had to turn in like the props that I used. So like, I lived with my grandma. Like, my grandma so like raised me. So so I had to turn in like the things that I used, but I never actually took any temperature readings.
That's
so
hilarious.
I found the thermometer that we had in the house, and I was like, I'm just gonna fucking turn this in with the thing, right? Because I need some stuff on my little board. And it got graded, and my teacher was like this old lady, and I guess she was familiar with these. But she's like, took me aside. She's like, I'm going to give you a 0 on your project for cheating. I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? I was like, I didn't cheat. And she's like, there's no way you could have taken these readings with a rectal thermometer. I was like, a what? And she's like, The thermometer you turn in is a rectal thermometer that doesn't go down to the temperatures that you fucking read. Like, it doesn't go in the 60s. I was like, whoops. Oh, well, I mean, I did the math. I was like, I just got both. She's like, nope, you're cheating. And actually, I was actually banned from National Honor Society for life for that. So it pissed me off because I was like, wow. fuck that. Like, I had an A except for that one thing.
Go ahead.
Well, so I protested after that in the class. I was like, fuck you. So I actually didn't do another assignment for the rest of the year in that class. So I had AAAAF for the fucking semester. And that was the only F I've ever gotten. I've actually only gotten...
So you protested despite the fact that you cheated?
Right. Well, I was mad because I did most of it. I just didn't fucking, you know, I didn't do the fucking bitch work part of it. And so in my eyes, it wasn't cheating, but I guess it was. So, yeah. That and handwriting in, like, I don't know, first grade. That was, like, a grade we got, handwriting. Those are the only two C's I've ever gotten in my life.
Yeah, I felt like such a shitbag every time I was in the National Honor Society. Because, like, I was in it, like, through welfare. Like, they didn't seem to give a shit how you got good grades. They just cared that you got them. So I got, like all the welfare... like normal kid grades in the normal kid classes.
Right.
Meanwhile, like these fucking, like, meanwhile, the place I should be, like, I should have been in the advanced classes, but I just didn't apply myself as much as I could. They're over there like working their ass off and I'm just cruising. And they did these like celebration things every report card. Every 6 weeks is when we got our report cards. They did these like big celebrations for all the people that were in the National Honor Society. Like this, they'd bring in pizza and all this shit, and I'd be sitting there eating pizza, kind of feeling a little guilty with all these other motherfuckers that worked all hard and shit. And I'm just like, yeah, whatever.
Here I am. What's up?
Yeah. One of my favorite stories when you're talking about projects is we had a geology teacher, and one of our things was that we had to bring in rocks that we found interesting, and I swear to God, this one kid brought in gravel. He brought in gravel outside from the road outside, and she fucking lost her mind. Not in the way that you would be thinking. She fucking lost her mind. She's like, oh my God, this is blah, 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 blah. Where did you find this?
That's fucking hilarious.
And he's like, yeah, I found it up on a hill somewhere. Meanwhile, I literally fucking saw the guy grab a handful of gravel.
Wait, she thought it was like legit, like
yeah,
rare
she thought
material.
It was like some crazy fucking rock. This dude grabbed a handful of gravel, put it in his fucking pocket, and walked in. Oh, nice. It's so fucking funny, dude.
Nice. That's hilarious. Yeah.
The best part is that he played it up. He's like, yeah, man, I found it on this hill.
That's hilarious. Yeah, I took AP calculus when I was in 12th grade, but I was scared of it in college for some reason, and I was like, that couldn't have been like real college class. Like, college has to be way harder than that. So I took it over again, and I was so fucking bored my first year because I had literally just taken the class like the second time. I ended up like not doing great in it because I didn't go to class. I never went to the lectures. I just went to like we had like a discussion and a homework turn in. I fucking never went. So like I was worried that I was going to actually miss like an exam because like I hadn't gone for like 3 or 4 weeks. But I found college to be pretty easy.
If you think that's brutal, you should see the fucking introductory computer science classes. Holy fuck, dude. It's literally like, click the X button to close out of a program. Like, it is fucking, like the introductory stuff, like, I realize it gets hard as fuck, but, like, oh my God. I only went to the college I went to for a semester because I wanted to do the YouTube thing, but holy fucking shit, dude. Right. So fucking boring.
I imagine. Because, I mean, like, you're in a class with, like, somebody who, like, fucking has never... You know what I mean?
It's just like, yeah, but, like, really? Are the people that are going into the computer science field, like, you're literally teaching them how to, like, use a fucking computer? Like, from the, like, very basic functions of, like, how to open up a, like, program?
Right. No, I see what you're saying. Yeah.
Like, I was expecting, like, introductory, like, coding and making, like, little fucking... programs that did shit, not like click the fucking X button.
I don't know how kids. So when I taught myself how to use computers, it was back when like I had to understand like DOS functionality. Like, you know what I mean? Like I had to know how to do a lot of, you know what I mean? Like there was a lot more shit to figure out.
Yeah, it was way harder, way less user friendly.
I don't know how, like, I don't know what the skill level of like nerds on that pick up computers today is. Like, I guess you can do basic functions. I guess what I'm saying is I don't know how kids teach themselves how to use computers like on a real level, because like everything's so like graphic user interface.
Yeah. Well, I know when I got a smartphone, I felt like an old person kind of like, cause I didn't have a smartphone for a long time, and smartphones are almost, it's like so simple that you feel like it's a trick. You're like, how do I get to this thing? It's like, oh, you just do this, like, really simple thing. I was like, oh, I was expecting it to be, like, deep in the options somewhere, you know? Right. You know what I mean? Like, it's almost like it's a trick question.
Right. Yeah, no, yeah, like that. yeah, I mean, because, like, I guess they're doing it for, like, to make it more accessible, but, like, that's why I hate shit like Windows 10. Like, and I always put it back on, like, Windows fucking 7 interface. Because, like, that shit was easier. Like, I don't like the fucking, you know what it is, where, like, the tiles and all that other bullshit. Like, I don't think that's
I like Windows 10 so far. No. The Windows 10 thing, that's not tiles.
Well, no. That's
like the tablet mode. Windows 10 is very, very similar to Windows 7 if you're using it in the PC mode or whatever.
Right. Right. It's better. Windows 8 was fucking full on AIDS. But I still don't think...
Yeah, Windows 8 was the one where it was like a forced tablet UI, right?
Yeah, and you had to download
app. Oh, so bad.
You had to download an app to get it to go
back.
Yeah,
because I remember that's what I thought Windows 10 was. And I was like, what the fuck? This shit is fucking dumb.
Yeah, like, if I want to do something... Like, what was the problem with opening, like, fucking... clicking programs and finding the program you want? Or going through Windows Explorer and opening... like. Why do I need...
Do you remember Windows Vista? That piece of dog shit?
Yeah. I used that, though.
I remember when Windows Vista came out, and my brother got a new... This is when my stepbrother got a new laptop, and he literally had three fucking clocks on his desktop. He had, like, the clock on the bottom right, like you'd expect. Then he had, like, a digital clock, and then he had a clock with fucking hands on it. Three clocks right next to each other. And that was the default.
Right. Yeah, that was like the app one, right? Like everything was a fucking app that you had to do in...
I can't. I just know I hated it.
Yeah, I'm with you. Yeah. But apparently Windows 10 is the last Windows. Apparently, like, they're just going to, like, start charging you a subscription and then, like, doing updates through, like, the... You know what I mean? Like, apparently, like, all
they're,
the...
They're not going to... Yeah.
So... We'll see. Yeah.
Who knows? Anyway. Yeah, that's weird. I mean, I can see it. Like, how much can you fucking improve? Like, I don't know.
Yeah.
All right. Let me look at my topic list here. Let's see. Oh, we can talk about the Milo Yiannopoulos thing.
Is that a big story though? I feel like that's,
you got
like
perma banned off Twitter for like rustling jimmies.
Yeah, did he though, or did they let him back on?
I think he's still permanently... I think he's probably going to stay permanently banned. Like, he literally hurt somebody's feelings, and they permabanned him. And that's not the first time they've done that, like, that sort of thing to him. Like, they took away his verified status because they just don't like him.
Who is he again?
He was a he's the gay conservative guy.
Yeah,
we've talked about him on the podcast before when Doug was on.
Oh, did we?
Yeah, he's a super flamboyantly gay conservative that is like an excellent debater. Like, he's like one of those guys that if you got into an argument with him, like, and you said the sky was blue and he said the sky was red, that you would still lose because he's just that good at fucking arguing. Like, he's got like YouTube montages of him just shitting on people in arguments, and he's just one of those guys. He's a provocateur. Just like one of those devil's advocate kind of people that is just really good at doing it.
Interesting.
But yeah, they permanently banned him on Twitter because he was talking shit about the Ghostbusters movie.
Yeah, I do know that. Well, it was the Leslie Jones or whatever her name is, right?
Yeah.
Isn't that like the...
The black, the big black woman.
How did that movie do, by the way?
Probably terrible.
Did it really do as bad as everybody thought it was going to?
I'm going to look up the Ghostbusters Rotten Tomatoes. Let's see. Ghostbusters. 73% of the critics liked it. 58% of the... I always go by the audience score. 58% of the audience liked it, which is better than I would have thought.
Right.
I don't ever... Movie critics are like fucking horseshit, like most of the time.
Well, it's because, like, I mean, a lot like... Much like fucking... probably a lot of things, they're all just probably paid off. You know what I mean? They're probably biased by whatever fucking parent company they fucking have. I mean, yeah. I'm with you. Like,
I feel like in a lot of ways, they just try to be the opposite. They try and like... If whatever, like if the movie is shit, they want to make it good. And if the movie is good, they want to make it shit.
Right. And there could be like a really like fucking artsy movie that's like dog shit to watch, but they really fucking love it. You know, I don't know. I'm still on the fucking Brown Bunny fucking kick from back in the day while they shit on that movie. But that movie had an actual blowjob in it. That's got to be like a 25% fucking positive review, even if nothing else happens in the entire movie.
Yeah, apparently. Oh, dude, Star Wars. I'm looking forward to more Star Wars shit.
Is there a blowjob in it?
No. Well, maybe.
What do you mean you're looking forward to it?
Oh, there's the new one coming out this December. The Rogue One. It's going to be...
Is that really a Star Wars movie? I mean, it is, but
yeah,
like,
it is.
It's like a sideways fucking thing, right? Like a alternate storyline kind
of
deal?
No, it's part of the main storyline. I think it's like before the Death Star blows up. It's like the events leading to the Death Star blowing up, but it's telling the story from the pilot's point of view. And right. Vader's in it. Darth Vader's in it. So there's going to be... I'm going to predict at the end of that movie they're all going to get massacred. I have a feeling that's how the movie's going to end. They're all going to get fucking massacred by Vader at the end.
Yeah,
that's
maybe.
That's one thing the movies never showed off with Star Wars. They never actually showed off how much of a real bad motherfucker Anakin Skywalker / Darth Vader was. Like, he fucked up everybody. It's like single-handed, like one-man army style. So I think they'll take that movie and really kind of show how much of a bad motherfucker he was.
Yeah, I wonder. Yeah, I mean, yeah, I mean, I'll see it for sure, but.
And then episode 8.
Right, that's not coming out for like a while, though, right?
That's not coming out until, I think, December of next year. That one's... They finished filming it. They finished filming it this week. So they're spending all of the next almost... They're spending over, like, almost 2 fucking years, basically, on just the special effects.
I didn't like that What's-His-Nuts wasn't even in the other one. Mark Hamill. Yeah, like he was in it for like what?
5 seconds.
Exactly. Like,
I like that movie a lot. I really like that the new Star Wars movie that came out.
Really?
The Force Awakens. Yeah, I thought I liked it a lot.
Yeah, I remember there was a big controversy, if I remember right, about the black stormtrooper, which I don't feel like should have been a controversy.
No.
But yeah, the black dude. That played the fucking...
Oh, I know you're talking about, but like, no, I don't think it should have been a controversy. That's fucking crazy.
But it was, though. It was like a huge deal when that fucking shit, like, maybe
I
it died
down.
I think
most people were fine with it.
Right, as I would hope, but yeah. Only thing, when I went into it, I was like, I just don't understand, like, if they're all clones of What's-His-Nuts. Like, where did this guy come from?
They're not all clones. They don't use the clones anymore.
Right, but they did, right? Like, that was the original... The original fucking stormtroopers were all clones of Dude Man. What's his name? I'm triggering a lot of people with me not remembering the guy's name. Was it Boba or Jango? Jenga.
No, Jango was his kid that wasn't a clone. That was like part of his thing. Or wait, no, Jango was the dad, right?
Jango's the dad.
Jango, but... no, they were all clones of Jango Fett, and Boba Fett was the son.
Right.
See, I'm a big Star Wars fan, but not like in the sense of like traditional movies. Like, I don't know that much shit about the old movies. But I like Star Wars, the extended universe stuff. And that's where I want them to go. Like, I hate that the new Star Wars... I hate that Star Wars has... These are the good guys and these are the bad guys. I really want them to do the gray area shit more. Like, the extended universe does the gray area stuff way fucking better. Where it's like, yeah, the Jedi do some fucked up shit and the Sith aren't all that bad. And, I just hate... Like, I really wish that the movies were more... I don't know. Like, I fucking hate how at the start of the movie, like, Kylo Ren just massacres that village of people for no reason. It's like, really? Like, he had to be just indiscriminately fucking evil? Like, he couldn't have, like, just a different mindset or different way of thinking about something? I don't know.
Dude, you're gonna get somebody really mad that hasn't seen it yet.
Oh, spoiler alert.
You just told him what happens.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I mean, I ended up watching, I actually hadn't seen... Before 7, I actually hadn't seen the originals, like, in their entirety.
I haven't seen them. Yeah, I haven't seen them in their entirety in, like, one sitting. I think I've seen them all, like, in parts, but, like, actually sitting down and watching them, like, not really.
Well, I did.
They're old. See, the thing with old movies is they're just kind of shitty, most of them. Like, even the Star Wars, like, in a lot of ways is just kind of shitty.
I would generally agree with you, but I don't know, man, like...
Like, some stuff stands up, but a lot of stuff just doesn't. I mean, that goes with almost anything. Like, if you go listen to really good old songs, like, I think, like, American Pie, like, that American Pie song, a lot of people think that's, like, a really good song, and it is a pretty good song, but, like, if you go and listen to the audio quality, it's like, wow, this shit actually sounds bad. Like, the audio quality of a lot of these songs are bad, and they're just, like, they've gotten better at making movies and entertainment and all that stuff in general.
Right. Yeah. I mean, I would say that that's true for... Some things, you know, some things have held up better. Like, I remember watching the original Indiana Jones movies, and I wasn't thinking they were too bad. And I didn't think the Star Wars ones were too bad either. But again, then again, I'm probably going to piss a lot of people off when
I see what movies like, held up excellently? The Lord of the Rings movies.
Yeah, but does Dallas. Yeah, but those, they spent a lot of money on those back when they actually did them. Like, they were pretty decent. You know what I mean?
But they're old as fuck now, and they still, like... Like, if Lord of the Rings came out now, it wouldn't be like, wait, what? Like, what is this? Like, it still looks good.
What do you mean old as fuck? When did they come out?
Pretty long time ago. 2001. You can go watch the original, like, if you go watch other movies from 2001, like, I wonder when that Scorpion King movie came out.
Yeah, but that was just low budget as fuck, dude. You know who you can't shit on, though, is the fucking Rock.
Well, the reason, yeah, the Scorpion King came out in 2002, and that movie, I'm sure you know what I'm talking about, like, with the, like, the horrible CG.
Yeah, like, but that's just a, like, budget comical issue. That's not but, a no, skill.
See, Lord of the Rings will consistently stand up till the end of time, because all of that shit was practical. Like, the orcs were people in fucking costumes. Like, they didn't use, like, tons of CG shit.
Right. But, I mean...
Like, the Warcraft movie, while it looks good as fuck now, and while it blows our mind now, we're gonna look at that shit in, like, 20 years and be like, wow, I cannot believe we thought this looks good. This looks like fucking ass.
Maybe. Yeah.
Like, we'll probably look at those orcs in Warcraft and be like, that looks like ass in 20 years.
Maybe. I don't know. Yeah, I mean... But only because, like... Like, at a certain point of realism, right? Like, you can't be more... The only thing they could do is increase, like, the fucking, like, resolution. You know what I mean?
It's or one like of those yeah, we're saying that now, but it's one of those things where until you actually see the new and improved, you don't realize how new and improved it's actually going to get.
Right. I'm just
like,
trying
they've
to
been
think.
Saying that about video game graphics for a really long time.
Yeah, but what could you, like...
It's the nuances. It's the little tiny fucking details that make all the difference.
Cause like I'm just like if you watch like one of the Blizzard cinematics, like the not the one not the Harbinger one, which was really good by the way, but the like the Legion intro one, like that's really good. But on stuff like that of older games, like you could say like, oh, they're missing the sweat. They're missing the eye nuances.
Yeah,
the,
yeah it
it's
depends
missing
on,
emotion.
It depends on like what it is too. Like, the Wrath of Lich King cinematic is one of the greatest fucking cinematics of all time. And it's going to hold up because it's not showing, like, faces or... and it's, like, a white bat, like white snow and cliffs and yeah, some of that stuff holds up. Like you can go and look at.
I'm just saying, like it's easy to like kind of pick out what a lot of these older things are missing. You know what I
yeah.
mean?
Oh
they're,
yeah.
They're,
yeah,
they're missing emotion. They're missing whatever.
But when it comes, I think the orcs in particular, though, with Warcraft, like anytime you have to humanize something, that is going to be really hard to keep that, to make that look good till the rest of the time. Like even the movies that come out 20 years from now are going to run into that same issue because there's so many little nuances and things that, you know, make right. stuff look real.
Yeah. Yeah. What just came out? I think there's like some movies that just I haven't been in the movies in forever because I've been watching them on my fucking Fire Stick that I got. I saw that movie. Oh, speaking about The Rock, dude, that guy is on fucking top of the world right now.
He's literally the highest paid actor in the world.
Yeah, but like, did you? You probably didn't see this movie, Central Intelligence, with Kevin Hart. Like he was in that movie. That shit is fucking hilarious, dude.
Like, oh, is that actually, the one? I think I've seen previews for that, where like The Rock is like a fat kid that gets bullied at the start of the movie.
Yes.
And yeah.
That's it. Yeah, that movie is fucking like super hilarious. Like it's really good, and his show Ballers is good. Like he's just I don't know. Man, should have saw that coming. I should have fucking hung on and that guy and been friends back in the day.
You know what I mean? Like, what, did you meet him?
No, I'm just saying, like, he was down in my area. I could have hung out with, if I knew who he was, I could have hung out with Marilyn Manson, too. He's from Fort Lauderdale. You know what I mean? Just like all these people that fucking blow up that you never would fucking think about. Imagine being in school, right, and knowing, like, what we know now, but going back then. And like seeing fucking awkward fucking Taylor Swift's ass in high school, or not even high school, but like middle school. You know what I mean? And just like being like.
Dude, I bet she was awkward as fuck because she's all like tall and lanky.
Yeah.
I bet she was like an awkward high schooler.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Or like Jennifer Lawrence, you know what I mean? Who's like fucking normal, but then became like the biggest thing ever. Like imagine like going back. Like, so let's do, like, if you went back, right, and you met Jennifer Lawrence in middle school. And you were a middle schooler, but you knew she was going to be like one of the biggest actresses in the world one day. Like, would you royally fuck it up, or do you think that you could pull it off?
I would try to wedge my way into her like career somehow and be like some sort of like friend mentor role or some shit. I don't know what I would do, but I would try to fucking get on the gravy train somehow.
You wouldn't try to be like her love interest. You would take a professional angle.
No, yeah, no, I'd take a professional angle. That's the way more consistent conservative route.
Right.
The love interest thing, that shit, there's like a really high chance of failure there.
Right, but I feel like it sounds bad, but like say I got to hit it, but like then all of a sudden she got bored and like moved on.
Then there's
whatever.
A song about you.
No, and then
your
no,
royalties
then,
like, off the song, bro.
Yeah, like you know she's like. She realized my wiener was too big or something and she had a problem with it. So, but like, then she goes on and I'm not in her life anymore and then she blows up. I'd still feel good knowing I hit it back in the day. But if I went the professional route and yeah. I like wanted to help her be a singer.
Oh, fuck. Who was the guy that fucked Kim Kardashian on that tip, on that tape?
Ray J.
Yeah, he made a song called I Hit It First. I swear
Which
to God.
Which is a really good song.
Dude, that's so had that on funny, my computer. Dude. That is so funny.
Yeah.
I hit it first. Dude, it's so fucking funny, man. What
man,
a joke.
Even that bitch, dude, Kardashian, dude, like, they're fucking God, dude. Like, can you imagine? Like, fucking, I don't know. I'd fuck pretty much anybody on camera to get as much money as that bitch has. You know, it's all from her stupid little fucking phone app, too. Like, her money comes from that. Like, the show's pretty good money, and, you know, blowing Kanye West, I think, is probably pretty good money. But, like, she made something like $40 or $50 million in a year from her fucking app, and something like 10 or 20 from the rest of her shit.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't hate her. She's fucking hustling. She turned a fuck tape into a multi-million dollar empire.
That's what I'm saying, dude. Like, I'm just
waiting
for...
That's the American dream, dude.
I'm just waiting for Kylie Jenner's fuck tape. That's what I really want to see. Like, she's the hot one. Yeah. No, well, maybe not anymore because of her fucking lips, but she's undoubtedly the hottest one. Kendall Jenner kind of looks like a fucking rat. She kind of looks like a hotter version of, like, Paris Hilton. I mean, I'd still put it in her, like, little rat butthole, of course, but, I mean, given the choice, I'd take the other one. Huh. Got it. What?
Oh, I take the Kindle chick more than the...
Really? No way, dude.
I think so. Maybe I'm Google imaging poorly.
Yeah, I mean, she's not bad. She just, you know, she doesn't have, like, she's a little more stickish. You know what I mean? Like, she's a little more... Kylie's got, like, a little more, like, fucking curviness to her.
Dude, our fucking, our people are going to hate us talking about this shit.
About Kardashians?
About the Kardashians, yeah. This is why they listen to the podcast.
First. Yeah, well, if they don't like it, then they want to fuck Bruce Jenner.
Yeah.
Yep.
Well, there you go.
That's what it is. If you don't like talking about Kardashian ass, that means that you would prefer talking about Bruce Jenner. Why was he at the Republican fucking thing?
Was he really?
I think he was. Yeah, actually. Pretty sure he was.
Did you see the Hillary Clinton attack ad? Like, the only reason I bring this up is because I was watching my dad's dog, and I was actually, like, just watching TV for the first time in forever, but, like, Hillary Clinton has this new attack ad on Donald Trump that's fucking hilarious. Let me see if I can find it on YouTube. It's basically just, like, Donald Trump sound bites. And that's all it is. Hillary Clinton.
You really think she's going to pull the gloves off in this debate? Like, I don't know what
I think they're both going to. I think it's going to be hilarious. What president
he hasn't, will this? He hasn't been nearly as, like...
I know, it's got to be coming, though.
He hasn't been nearly as, like, fucking... I don't want to say dirty, because that's not the right word, but, like... He hasn't been nearly as, like, fucking... aggressive. You know what I mean? Now that he actually has the nomination. Which I guess is,
yeah, like, I'm waiting for him to fucking... turn the shit up.
Right.
Elves.
I could just hasn't. Did you see that he basically, there was a thing that supposedly came out proving he didn't want the job because he offered to make John Kasich like the most powerful vice president in history, and Kasich's group was like, well, how's that? And he's like, you'll pretty much do everything. I'll just be the guy who hangs out. And then they're like, what would you actually do then? And he goes, make America great. That was his fucking answer. So apparently, yeah.
Yeah, this attack ad is just Donald Trump sound bites with like kids
when
watching
Mexico
the TV.
When Mexico sends its people, they're bringing drugs, they're bringing crime.
Paint ads.
You could see there was blood coming out of her eyes.
It's just kids watching a TV with Donald Trump talking. Our children are watching.
Our children and grandchildren will look back at...
Yeah, the one that they show on TV is shorter than that. It's just like 30 seconds of condensed Donald Trump ridiculousness. I couldn't find the 30-second one.
What's her point with that? Like, that fucking kids are watching, so you can't say those things? Like, do you really
want...
Yeah,
it's kind of stupid. I just thought it was funny. I just thought it was funny because it's all it is just Donald Trump going like... The 30-second ad is funnier because it doesn't even have Hillary Clinton in it. It's just Donald Trump soundbite, Donald Trump soundbite, Donald Trump soundbite, and it's like our kids are watching.
Right.
This is endorsed by Hillary Clinton for America.
Yeah. I don't know, man. I was trying to, you know, I had my kid all weekend. I have her every weekend now. I think about that.
You sound like you're fucking divorced.
Huh? No. Like, well, I mean, that's kind of how it works out with our work schedules. She works Friday night and Saturday night. And then she sleeps during the day. So pretty much from Friday night until Sunday, like afternoon, I have the kid to myself. And I think about like that kind of shit sometimes, like, you know, like how worried I'm going to be and shit like that. And I know like some dads like are getting the shotgun and whatever. What's funny is like I dated this girl.
No, don't do that. That shit's fucking retarded.
No. But what I'm saying is like I don't mean a literal shotgun. I mean like they're like super protective and blah, blah, blah. And I dated a... My wife is so dumb. She just texted... So
nice!
Let me just tell you like why I just said that. So I get DC'd at night randomly. Pretty much every night for the last couple of months, I just randomly get DC'd. Like I'll be playing a game or something, and my internet will just drop, and I got to reset my router, my cable modem, it comes back, right? So I'm like, I don't know if it's the router or the cable modem. I got to go buy one or the other because it's obviously one of them, I think. So last night, I unplugged the router to hardwire my computer to the cable modem directly to see that if I get DC'd, right? To see what the issue is. So we have, you know, the Fire Stick and the other thing. When I came up here to do the podcast, she was like, "Did you unplug the router? The internet is down." Because she was trying to, like, watch, I guess, like, the Fire Stick or the PlayStation or something.
Oh,
so geez. I just texted her, yes. And she just sent me another text message that says, "Well, how do I use the internet? How are you podcasting without internet?" It's fucking retarded. Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, yeah.
She should take an IT class.
Dude,
a college-level IT class.
She asked me, like, the most fucking ridiculous shit, like, half the time, and I just have to be like, anyway, what was I gonna say? Oh,
you're
yeah,
talking about
so, like,
being overprotective,
so
or whatever.
I used to date this girl, and we went on this trip with her family. Her parents are really cool, and we were staying in like this, like, it's kind of like a hotel deal, but it's like a house they rented down in Tampa. And like, her parents were like, "Hey, you guys take this room, blah blah blah, like, fucking don't keep us up at night." It was like kind of awkward. Because, like, their dad was, like, joking with me about how I was about to get ready to ream out his daughter. So, like, that was
Thanks,
a little
dad.
Weird. But at the same time, like, I kind of appreciated that he understood that his daughter was, like, a fucking, you know, like, mid-20s woman that, you know what I'm saying? Like, there
yeah,
was something
he wasn't,
sort of,
he wasn't bullshitting. Like, he's a fucking, he's been a 20-year-old guy before, too. Like
right.
At least, yeah.
Right. Like, so, like, I don't know. I kind of hope, not like that. I mean, well, I don't know, but I just kind of...
You're
going to
be giving,
like,
the guys pointers?
Yeah, listen. Exactly. Listen.
Listen, if I don't hear her, you're fucking up.
Yeah. No, not like that, but I just think that, like... I don't know. I don't understand people that are, like, super... I think if you, like,
my
fucking...
My mom was like that.
And crazy about your kid, like, that's just going to mean your kid's going to do crazier shit when they're not around you.
Dude. So my mom was super... Like, I never went crazy, but, like... yeah, like...
You got, like, brothers and shit, though, don't you? You have, like, an actual family.
Oh, I always say I have four older brothers, but they're stepbrothers. Well, I have one real, like, blood brother, but they're stepbrothers, but they're close enough to where it's fucking whatever. We don't really call each other that. But anyway, yeah, so, like, I never went, like, crazy and did anything, like, ridiculous, rebellious, but, like, my mom was so sheltering that I think it was, like, a legitimate parental mistake. Like, I was so fucking frustrated as a kid in a lot of situations because of, like, just the overbearing, overparenting by my mom. And a lot of that, I think, maybe was because my parents' marriage wasn't very good. Like, as soon as my parents got divorced, like, this might be fucked up to say, but, like, when my parents got divorced, dude, I was so fucking relieved. Like, because I was finally free, like, to, like, live my fucking life and do what I wanted to do. And, like, I literally had a fucking bedtime until I was 18. Like, that's crazy. I'm not even joking, dude. I'm not even joking.
Wait, like, my mom was
overbearing.
So you're, like, 16 years old, and you're
and my mom
house.
Was like, yep, it's fucking 10 o'clock. Not even 10:30, bro. 10 o'clock. Dude, she was so
What would you do if
over...
you just, like, you just stayed up? Like, I would have been
no,
like, yeah,
no, she would
it.
Literally unhook the internet and... at extreme times, turn the power off to my room via the circuit breaker.
Dude, I completely understand you now.
Dude.
That's fucking retarded. Did you ever go, dude, hey, you're being fucking retarded?
Yes. Dude. Yeah.
Like, why? Were you ever like...
You know
hey.
How... So, you know how a lot of times, like, a lot of people will talk about their parents... Like, when they're older, they'll be like, yeah, I realize why my parents did that thing now, and, like, it shaped me into the person, blah, 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 blah. Like, I understand why my parents never let me do that thing I always wanted to do. Now that I'm older, I get where they're coming from, right? Not at all, yep. Dude. Not with my I feel like my mom made some serious fucking parental errors with me in particular. She was, like, really anti-video game. Like, oh, my God, those video games are the worst things ever. She would... The reason I didn't get Gladiator, one of the reasons I didn't get Gladiator in season 7 is because my mom would fucking unhook the internet randomly. Like, she would just fucking unhook the internet.
We had a kid in my old guild that was like that. He would always have, like, issues with his fucking mom, like, fucking with him.
It made me so, dude, it even makes, I'm still fucking mad about it, dude.
You sound kind of triggered, honestly.
Dude, it was so fucking frustrating. It just frustrates the shit. Even thinking about it right now, like how unfair it was. Like, oh. Man. But anyway, like I was saying about being overprotective, like my mom.
Do you have like chicks at your house and your mom no, was just dude. Like, keep the door open?
No, I've never even introduced a girlfriend to my mom to this day. Like, really? This shit cuts deep, dude. I don't want to say I hold a grudge, but like, dude, it's like even today I feel like my relationship with my mom is fucking shit because she was such a fucking asshole when I was a kid. Like, wow. I hope you're not listening to this, Mom. Fucking A. Dude, I was so fucking frustrated as a teenager. It's unreal.
You should have just done something, like, ridiculous. Like, you should have just been, you should have just, like, had porn and just, like, openly whacked it when she came in. And just be like, that's what you get for barging in. And then just, like, stare at her while you continue to whack it.
Oh, I just did shit. Like, the one thing I did to fuck with her to retaliate is that I just wouldn't talk to her. Like, she would, like, that's the only way I could fuck with her. And I just did it out of spite. Like, it was a hard thing for me to maintain. Like, my mom thought I was, like, a legit, like, depressed sociopath or something. Because I just got so fucking mad. And there was no way that I could do anything about it. Because it's the most unfair shit ever. So whenever she would talk to me, yes, no, one word answers for, like, years. And, like, to this day,
Jesus Christ. Dude,
to this fucking day, I still am short with her. Not like because I hate her anymore. It's not because of like the hatred, but like I feel like since I did that for so long, that's like almost the way like I know how to communicate with her now. So like I still kind of do the same thing. Like, I feel like this is kind of just a thing you do on the phone in general when you're talking to people. You're like, yep, I know, yep. But still, dude, oh, bad times, man. That shit was so fucking dumb. And I just got ambushed, like when, because I had like very, like I wasn't like an anti-social person, like I had pretty good social skills, even though I was like really sheltered, but like I just got ambushed by like ridiculous, like all that ridiculous bullshit that you like got prepared for in high school, like all the awkward party shit and drunk sluts and all that shit that I never got to experience in high school, like all of a sudden I just get fucking ambushed by it when I'm in my 20s. And I'm just not fucking prepared. So wow. It's definitely trial by fire with a lot of these social situations that I just had no experience with in high school. Because, wow. You got to be in bed by 10, bro.
I was raised by my great grandmother and my grandfather, obviously. He died like midway through high school. But they were kind of oblivious to, especially like modern day things. Like, this is kind of an embarrassing. I actually don't recall a lot of this because it's just not a story. I don't think I've ever told anyone this story. But so I told you like I was on a BBS and I had like gaming sort of friends. I can't remember how I ended up meeting this dude, but he was older. I don't remember how old he was. Cause I was young. I'm pretty young. And, we played video games. I'm not sure, like, in what capacity we did. I mean, this is really hazy, but I just remember, like, I knew this guy, and he was kind of an acquaintance, and he lived, like, in our fucking area. Pretty sure he was gay, and he ended up, like, I think he was, like, trying to, like, I don't know what he was trying to do. Maybe he was trying to fuck me or something, but I met him at the mall. I'd never met this guy before. I got my great-grandmother to take me to the mall. And I had made some, like, bet with this dude that I ended up winning because I beat him in some game. And he bought me a it was a system. It was a game system. I don't remember which one it was.
This sounds like,
it was like
the
200...
intro to a rape story.
It probably was leading to it. And it was, like, $200. And I think it might have been I think it was Nintendo 64. So they were about $200, weren't they? Like $165, something
probably.
Like that.
Probably. I was 7.
Yeah. And he bought me that. And just from this like bet, I guess he had like some money or whatever, and he was trying to get on my good side. I guess we can, I don't know.
Fuck you.
Again, I had never met this dude ever. So I met him at the mall real quick. He bought me the fucking thing, and like we went on our way. And my grandma was like, where did you get that? Because she knew it was expensive because it was in a big bag, you know, and I didn't have any fucking money. And I was like, some dude I just traded some games to gave it to me. And she's like, oh, okay. And we, like, got in the car and we just fucking left. Like, it's the creepiest shit. I don't know what happened to that guy. I never
met
him again.
That is fucking weird.
Yeah, isn't it? That's fucking, I almost got sexual
what,
predatorized.
What game did you beat him in?
I don't know, dude. I'm trying to remember. It had to have been online because
How long was this, like, how long was this whole event? Was this, like, a 30-minute thing of an hour?
When I met him at the mall?
Yeah, yeah. How
it
long?
It was literally, I met him outside of, what was the store? EB Games? Remember okay. the old, yeah, I met him outside of EB Games, and he was like, hey, what's up? And I was like, how's it going? I was like, you got my shit? Like, not really, but basically, again, it's kind of hazy. And he was like, yeah, and he just gave
Are
it to
sure
me.
Are you sure you didn't get, like, drugged
no.
and raped?
No, like, no, I'm telling you.
It's kind of hazy.
You, I was like, what's up? And I was like, he was like, I was like, hey, you got my thing for the bed or whatever? He's like, man, you know, made some joke, I think. And he gave it to me, and I was just like, all right, well, I'll see you later. And I fucking took off and found my grandma and fucking went home.
How old was this guy?
I don't remember. He was old. He was older than me, though, by a number of years. He wasn't, like, old. He wasn't, like, 35. He was, like, probably, I'd say he was, like, mid-teens or something, and I was, like, young.
And then he went, did he buy this thing brand new from the EB Games?
Yeah. Bought brand new. Just bought brand new.
I bet that dude's
pissed.
You fucking.
No, he knew, like, what was this? I think he was, like, mentally fucked up. I don't know, dude. Probably a predator.
You seem like a real scumbag, bro. You're not putting out.
And
after he buys you an N64?
I'm telling you, bro, like, in my Jesus. nothing in my life, like, gave me the danger signal. Like, I knew he was kind of weird, you know what I mean? But I was just like, well, whatever. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know why. I don't know. But anyway, yeah, that was kind of, I don't know why I just told everybody that story. They're going to think I got fucked when I was, like, 8. But I remember it because it's fucking weird, right? Like, how often does that shit happen? The guy probably was, like, a freak. I bet he's, like, in jail now, but
whatever, bro. You got an N64.
I got an N64 out of it, so I guess it was worth it. I don't know. Anyway,
yeah. But. So I've actually got a story with my mom, and so, like, my mom was super anti video game. And I don't know if maybe I've told this story before, but when I got my first Machinima paycheck, like, she was so against video games. Would, like, consistently tell me that, like, I'm wasting my life. Video games are a waste of time. There was one Christmas where I literally got nothing for Christmas because I wouldn't tell it. Because I was just so fucking pissed off that she wouldn't accept that I liked playing video games. That, like, they asked me what I wanted for Christmas and I said nothing. Because I just out of spite, just to say fuck you. Like, fuck you for not liking the thing I like and not supporting me at all. So I just didn't get anything for Christmas that year. It's fucking pretty next level. But, anyway, so she fucking hated video games so much. And she had her own business. And I remember, this was when I finally got my Machinima paycheck. The very first one that was, like, 6 months delayed. So it was, like, pay for 6+ months when YouTube was paying out really well. And I'd obviously just started, so I wasn't big on YouTube at the time. But this check was for, like, 10 grand. And I made her fucking open it. Because I, like, had my, like, hands dirty. I was like, just open it, see what's inside. I don't know what it is. And it's a check for, like, 10 grand. And meanwhile, her fucking... Oh, shit. Felt so good, dude. It felt so fucking good.
What was she like? She's like, you're sending this shit back. You know what I mean? Like,
because she had nothing to say. Because, like, her business wasn't doing very well. And the thing she hated most, I was getting success with. Oh, dude, it felt so...
I hope her business, like, was doing it, better than 10 grand in 6 months.
It was losing money.
Oh, well.
Yeah. Yeah, but it was nice. It's a good fucking day, dude. And I was 15 years old when I got that?
What'd you do with 10 grand when you were 15?
Saved it. I've saved all my YouTube money, basically. Outside of, like, basic living costs, saved it. Because, I mean, I was very mature. A lot of these fucking dudes, a lot of these YouTubers, like, spent all their like, early money. Like, because the thing with YouTube, well, with the gaming in particular, back in the early days, like, the summer months were crazy because, you know, all the kids are out of school watching video game videos, right? So a lot of these fucking YouTubers were just spending money like crazy because we were making money like crazy in the summer months. And fucking that shit didn't last because the kids went back to school and then YouTube started paying out a little bit less and then ad block and mobile viewing came around, and just the ad rates have gotten worse over the years.
Right. Yeah. I mean, yeah, dude. I mean, yeah.
But that's fucked up. It's fucked up to say that, like, just that spiteful moment is legitimately one of the best, like, highlights in my life. Like, if I had to, like, list, like, top 10 moments ever for me, that one is maybe on the list.
Do you think that fucked up situation, like, with your mom is gonna, like... Like, when? What's your longest, like, relationship? Like, with a chick?
Probably close to 2 years, maybe.
Like, that should have some, like, impact on, like, the kind of chicks you pick out, or, like, your interpersonal shit.
I couldn't think of any. Like, I don't think so, but it has to, obviously, because all of your life decisions mold you. Like, everything molds you into the person that you are, so I'm sure it does. But I wouldn't be able to, like, give you a specific example of, like, this is a red flag, because...
Yeah, like, so what's weird about me is, like... So my wife now is, like, super passive. Like, I can say whatever. She doesn't give a fuck. Like, I make fun of her all the time. She doesn't care. Like, you know what I mean? Like, that's just...
I don't like that. I like them to be a little feisty.
Yeah, well... Well, I don't, because I know. See, the thing is
women are meant to be seen, not heard.
No. It's because we end up fighting, because, like, I just, like, I'm a super sarcastic, like, fucking dude who always needs to get, like, I don't know, like, I can't, you know what I mean? So, like, when I was growing up, right, I had my great-grandma who raised me, again, passive person, but my best friend was 4 years older than me. He was a next-door neighbor. And he was a fucking smartass, but, like, he was older than me, and he had heard and seen a lot more shit, so he was better at talking shit. So, like, everything I would fucking say, he would have, like, a much better fucking counter for, and he would, like, fucking, I don't know how to say it, but he would, like, just fucking own me.
He's a shit talker. He's just...
Mal
Davin, we've talked about him on the podcast. You haven't heard him, but, like, that guy is the best ever.
Right, so that dude is a
fucking god at shit talking.
So, I had somebody who was, like, submissive, and then I had this my friend who I had to learn how to spar with, right? And then I got pretty good at talking shit and being sarcastic and having comebacks and blah blah blah. So, I developed that way, like, basically, like, you know, sort of like a aggressive, sort of like interpersonal dynamic. So always, like, the super strong, like, women I haven't been good with, because, dude, I end up getting in fights with them because the internet, I'll tell them they're fucking stupid all the time.
The internet has done that to me. Being a YouTuber / Twitch streamer has turned me into a very, like, calculated person when it comes to, like, shit talking and stuff. Like, and maybe this is fucked up, but, like, anytime I meet somebody, or anytime, like, I know I'm going to be, like, seeing that person over and over again, I will start mentally, like, taking notes in my head of ways that I could, like, shit on them. Like, just, like, ways I could just, like, shit on them. If they shit on me, I need to have, like, five fucking things. Like, five nukes ready to go.
Right.
Yeah, I just do that now because of YouTube. Like, because I'm just...
What about YouTube?
But, well, because, like, people... I'm so used to people, like... Like, obviously, if you make 2,000 plus videos, I think I have almost 3,000 videos on YouTube, and I have to constantly, you know, answer the comments of people that are, like, shitting on me, or, I just, you know, obviously people shit on, no matter who it is, but you're gonna get shit on. Right. So I think just experiencing that for 5 years and having people on Twitter debate me and people on Twitter, like, try and fuck my shit up, it's just really turned me into... It's made me better. Tear me down and build me back up again stronger.
Yeah. I don't think a lot of people are prepared. Like, if you just come out of nowhere and you just come online and you become an online personality, I think that's why so many of, like, these young celebrities get fucked up. You know what I mean? Because, like,
they're not used to it. Yeah.
Well, that and, like, in athletes, dude, too. People, like, are, I wonder,
fucking mean. People say some shit that is... Sometimes people say some shit that's so fucked up, I actually laugh. Like, even if it's about me, I'm like, wow, that's fucking hilarious, but terrible.
Right. I think that's why, because like I look at like college athletes, right? Like, because I went to UF, huge football school, and I'm like, how can you blow your fucking like $1 million easy ass fucking life you have ahead of you by some stupid decision? But like, I don't know, man. These people like thrive on it. Like, if you know, that once you like retire from sports and shit, like your whole like sense of self is built around like the crowd loving you, and then all of a sudden, no one gives a fuck about you,
unless like, you're the opposite. Unless you're a Floyd Mayweather, which is what I am. I like it when people hate me more than when people like me. Like I, like when Swifty got banned, everybody's fucking hating on me, dude. I was on cloud nine. I wasn't at the time because I was still like an early on. But if that shit happened to me again, I would love it.
Right. But well.
Like when I post that shit on Twitter and everybody's like, "Fuck you, baby," I get so much enjoyment out of that.
Yeah. Pretty sure that is some sort of illness.
It could be.
Yeah, I mean, I get that. I mean, I don't know. I think, though, that your brand is not built on, like, super positivity. You know, and
it's fun being the villain.
You really don't rely on your shit anyway. You know what I mean? If that was your day-to-day, you know what I mean, and your only source of income, you might care a little bit more about having a broader, like, appeal.
Yeah, but I just think it's fun to be the villain, too. Like, I just don't want to be one of these mother, like, one of 10 million people that walks around on ice skates trying not to say anything that could hurt somebody's feelings, or, you know, not calling out somebody for being a dumbass because it might hurt somebody's feelings. Like, it's fun to be the, I wouldn't say I play the villain, because I definitely don't think I'm the villain all the time, but I definitely like to play the villain every now and then.
Right.
Like, with the legacy servers. Like, I made that video about, did you see that video I made about the legacy servers that blew up? Basically saying how they're a shit idea, and how it's like, I was like the only video like that for a really long time, and I was like, and I had so many other like YouTubers and like WoW people that were like, dude, I agree, and I was like, why didn't you make a video? He's like, I'm not crazy like you. So it's fun. I got a lot of enjoyment out of Kungan and his legion of autistic morons.
Does he still do anything? Like.
I'll check on his stream. If he's still doing legacy server shit, I'm going to cry. Kungan Twitch. If he is still making... That's what he did for a long time, is just talk about legacy servers.
I remember he had, like, a fucking graph. And, like, you know, the graph was, like, on his stream for, like, 12 hours.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He's still talking about it.
He doesn't have any of his past broadcasts available.
Yeah. Speaking of, WoW, have you been on the pre-patch?
No, I haven't played... I don't think I've played WoW since Overwatch just came out. The Legion Alpha or anything.
Man, dude. It's good, man. I a lot of my ex-Mythic friends are back in action. And the specs are really good, honestly. Like, I don't think I've seen a spec that I feel like has...
It probably will be a pretty good expansion. Except,
nope, Holy Paladin. Holy Paladin is worse.
Isn't the way Holy works is you have to be close to people to heal them or something?
Unless you talent out of it, yeah. And the way yes, and they've made you sort of into this martyr. So like you're one of your like main heals is Light of the Martyr, which is it hits you for 50% of the heal that it puts out, but it's an instant. So it just feels clunky as shit. Like, you don't feel like you have a good kit for no matter what happens. And yeah, some people will say, like, well, you know, they were the single target healers, and that's, you know, niches are good and blah blah blah, but you, I mean, running like Mythic Dungeons and running other things, like, you want to be able to react to things, you know what I mean? And they fucked Holy Paladins up. I think I just don't like it at all. But other than that, I mean, you know, they've made things weirder, but in some cases, but it's all really good, dude. Like, Shadow Priest is 10 times better than it ever was. Demo Warlock is really fucking good. Yeah, you should try it. I don't know about Feral Druid. I think that, like, it's probably
Feral Druid is just the same shit. Unless they have changed it since the last time I played, it's literally just the same shit it's been since, like, Wrath. Like, it's slightly, barely ever changed since Wrath.
Yeah, but I think, weren't they, I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure they were one of the, like, two specs that actually kept dot snapshotting, weren't they?
Yeah, I think so.
Right, which means that...
Because I remember looking at talents and I was like, didn't they take out the snapshotting thing? Yeah, the Feral Druids always had a really high skill cap with DPS, so them leaving it in makes
their
sense.
Their kit has been good, though. Like, they haven't been... Like, there are some specs that have been literal aids, and that's
why...
Yeah,
the Feral Druids have always had a really fun skill-oriented rotation ever since Wrath, which is... We talked about this with the podcast with Hotted, where, like, it's not that it's bad, it's just that it has been the same for fucking forever. Like, it's the only thing I can think of that's just been the same for that long.
I mean, they added some things, right? They gave you... Yes, they did. They gave you the ability to use... what's the blue single-target dot as a range puller? Lunar something or other.
But nobody uses that.
No, no one does, but you could use it. I used it for questing. I used it for questing on the Timeless Isle because I would pull...
That was
frogs.
One thing I was excited about Legion... Not Legion... Warlords. I was like, oh shit, they're giving us another dot with Moonfire. That could actually be cool, right? Nope, it's just not viable at all. It's just terrible, terrible fucking talent. The whole expansion.
Yeah, I mean...
Yeah, but ever since Wrath, it's been
Blood Talons,
Savage
right?
Roar, Mangle, Rake, Rip, Fairy Fire. And I think they took Fairy Fire. Is Fairy Fire even a thing anymore? But ever since that, it's been keep Mangle up, keep Rake up, keep Rip up, keep Savage Roar up, shred.
If I had to guess, and I don't know this to be true... Let me look it up real quick. If I had to guess, I would say that... Hang on. Let me just go to the noob method and just go to Icy Veins real quick so I can see the talent tree.
The one thing they did add was, like, Skull Bash. The Skull Bash interrupt was something new they added in Cataclysm. And then they made Skull Bash reset Tiger Siri, which was cool as fuck. But that didn't change any of the core, like, DPS of the spec or anything like that. But that was cool that they added.
Use the rotation, single target rotation, rake, shred, rip, and bite.
Wait, is Mangle not even a thing anymore?
I don't know if that's in your kit or not. I know you have swipe. You mean thrash?
Oh, I think they took Mangle. I think Mangle wasn't even in fucking Warlords.
Mangle is a bear thing.
Yeah, Mangle. They took Mangle out. When did they take Mangle out? Maybe they took that out in
Cataclysm. You know how many comments we're going to get about, like, you guys don't even fucking know, blah, blah.
Well, it's been the same, but they made it fucking easier then.
So, like,
if they
here's
took
the
Mangle out, that's just the one less thing you got to do.
So here's a good example. Like, here's all the talents for Feral Druid. Tier 1 is the cooldown on Tiger's Fury resets when a target dies with one of your bleeds active. Or... Your melee abilities in cat form have 10% increased crit chance on targets with a bleed active, which
well,
is obviously the talent.
Stupid. Why is that even a choice?
Obviously the talent to take. And then the last one is Moonfire is usable in cat form, generates a combo point, and deals damage based on attack power and costs 30 energy. So obviously you take Blood.
It's the middle one, yeah.
They've got the Displacer Beast. They've got the Affinities, which don't do a lot. Mass Entanglement, Mighty Bash, or Typhoon. Savage Roar is a talent now, so that's not even baseline. So you can either have Savage Roar.
It'll probably be the best one, though, because that's what they always do, usually.
Or, no, well, it's according to Icy Veins, and again, I don't know who did this, so accuracy is... it says, if you have the Archimonde Trinket, Incarnation, King of the Jungle is the best choice in all situations.
That's fucking retarded.
Which is a cooldown. And then it says, if you do not have that trinket... Savage Roar is a better choice in all situations, except for extremely short encounters under 1 minute, at which point Incarnation is still best. Soul of the Forest is otherwise only really useful outside of raids, which is your finishing moves grant 8 energy per combo point. So that's that. So I guess you still do take Savage Roar.
I thought you were saying Savage Roar was the worst one. Never mind.
It's between that or the cooldown, which I would take Savage Roar for being out in the world. But and the next one is Ferocious Bite always refreshes the duration of Rip.
That's fucking dumb.
Or your Rip, Rake, and Thrash abilities deal the same damage as normal, but in 40% less time.
Well, fuck yeah. I've looked at these talents before. They've changed them up a little bit. But yeah, that's clearly the fucking winner.
Immediately grant 5 combo points and an additional 1 every 1 second for 5 seconds. Yeah, of course you take that one. And then the last one is either... Brutal Slash, which strikes all enemies blah, 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 gives you a combo point. Blood Talon, which is the same thing that you've always had where you do the healing touch for the next two melee abilities. So you put that on your dots.
Yeah, that is a cool thing that they added in Warlords, that Blood Talons thing, but it's a fucking dumb mechanic.
I wonder
because
you just
randomly heal like nothing. Like, it's fucking stupid.
It's good for being in the world, right? Because, I mean, like...
Yeah, but in raids, it's silly as shit.
I mean, it helps with healing. Like, I guess for that, though, predatory swiftness has to be a thing, though. Right? Like, because if they took that away...
No, it is.
Yeah. So, yes, it pretty much is the
same. But it's just silly as fuck. Like, I mean, I remember raiding in Warlords, and I was like, okay, I just set up a macro to heal the fucking main tech with the random fucking healing touch every now and then. It's just... It's not... I wish that was just something else other than healing. Like, I like the mechanic of snapshotting the dot.
I just healed myself. You actually healed the tank?
Yeah. I'm typically at high health.
Right.
So but you just set a macro to heal the tank.
I wonder if they made that thing where you're a cat and you get like 10% more fucking healing. I wonder if that's still a thing. It's just baseline now. I bet it is.
I remember being a talent in Wrath. It's like nurturing instinct or whatever.
Right.
But, I like how I still remember that shit. God damn it. It's like burned into my brain.
What's weird is that the glyphs now are put right onto your spellbook. So like there's still glyphs in the game, but you click them and apply them directly to the spell in your spellbook.
Rip inscription, I guess.
No, not really. I mean,
the whole
it's just
thing is glyphs, right?
Yeah, but what they have in Legion are this thing called Vantus runes, which give you 1,000 versatility versus a specific boss every week. So, like, if you're stuck on the third boss, you take that Vantus rune and you get like a buff for that boss. So they have those. They have
That's actually kind of cool.
They have Dark Moon cards, obviously, like they always do.
That's actually good for inscription because it gives them like consistent things to make. Because like the thing with glyphs is that once you get the glyphs, you don't need them anymore.
Right. And the other thing is these fucking tomes, like these change your talent when you're out in the fucking world things. I sold those. I sold them for like 40 gold each. Like they sell really good. So.
Well, you can't just buy the things off the vendor anymore.
Oh no! Nope. Crafted by inscriptionists.
That's good. That's a good change because the shit's fucking.
Yeah, but that is the dumbest thing they've ever changed in the history of WoW. That and the zoom out thing. Like you would probably hate the zoom out thing.
No,
so
I didn't play that zoomed out.
Well,
I can see why they wanted to change the zoom out thing because a lot of the top players were playing like essentially an RTS. Like if you watch a lot of the top like Affliction Warlocks, they were playing so zoomed out, like it was ridiculous.
Yeah, but
I don't think
to.
They. You don't have to. It's an advantage, but I can see why. I see both sides of it, obviously.
Well, like if you're on
Blizzard, doesn't want their game to be spectated like that. That's what it is.
When you're on, well, right? Okay. Well, if that's the thing, but like when you're on, like I remember on doing Heroic Lei Shen when that was progression, and there was a lot of like precision movement that you had to do. Like, the way to do precision movement is obviously moving with your mouse, but secondly, going way up in the fucking air. You know what I mean? Directly over your character so that you know where you're moving to. I don't know. I guess I'm used to it now.
Yeah, they just don't want their game spectated. They don't want videos and, like, they want people to actually see the game and be, like, more immersed in the game and have the videos and the streams be like that, too.
Right.
And I'm not that upset about it because I didn't play that zoomed out. Like, I didn't use scripts to zoom out super fucking far. Like, they give you a lot of zoom distance still.
Yeah.
That's one thing Crowfall's doing is they're not letting you zoom your camera out super far on purpose. So.
Yeah, the only thing where it sucks is you do get, like, some weird camera shit and you get, like, stuck near walls and with mobs and you can't actually see anything sometimes. But hopefully they'll minimize that in whatever the fuck raid it is. But it's good, man. I recommend anybody to come try the pre-patch out before Legion. Because I'm telling you, the specs are a lot better. Transmog thing, dude. I made so much fucking gold when I vendored everything on my account. That thing's really good.
So void storage is like actually pointless now, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Nice.
So literally, like, every leather thing I've had across my entire account is now, as long as it's not class specific, transmoggable on any leather wearer. Like if I go make a druid on some other server, I can wear my fucking tier shit as soon as, pretty much whenever. So it's cool though. I mean, it's the first day of the patch, like all my friends did was like fucking vendor their shit and like, you know what I mean? But yeah, dude. A lot of the specs that I like abandoned are now like some of the most fun in the game, like enhanced frost decay, all that kind of shit, really good. So, but yeah, man, that's it.
So you want to switch topics?
Yeah. Actually, I don't have too much longer. Probably like 10 more minutes.
Okay. One second. Let me look here. Did you see about the Russian doping shit?
I heard that they were going to get banned and then they didn't.
Yeah, they're banned from the Olympics. It's pretty hilarious. So the lead Russian anti-doping guy was secretly doping all of the Russian, was like secretly hiding all of the doping that the Russian athletes were doing.
I did hear about that. Yeah, and he was in, yeah.
Yeah, and like, this was state sponsored. Like they literally had like the, essentially like the Russian FBI helping them do this shit.
Yeah, I did see that. What did I see? I saw it on like John Oliver talked about it, and there's like all these different organizations, and all of them pretty much like fed this one corrupt fucking thing who was like in on it. Dude, did you see? What's his nuts? Colbert, like trolled the RNC.
Yeah, he went in like Hunger Games.
Yeah, like, but costume. he got up on stage and he was like, the 2016 Hunger for Power Games is eventually commenced. And he like had his like shit on and like they like jerked him off the stage and he was like, whoa, he's like, I know I'm not supposed to be up here, but let's be honest, neither is Donald Trump. like they actually,
I can't believe
like,
he managed to get on stage.
Yeah,
security, it was before, there must suck dick.
Well, it was before they actually like kicked off. You know what I mean? Like it was like there weren't a lot of people in the auditorium yet. So, like, that's how he just kind of walked up there. It wasn't, like, a big deal. I mean, the guy was up there in, like, 2 seconds, but still pretty funny.
I'm still waiting for death at a Trump rally.
Yeah, I don't think you're going to get it, man. He calmed down a lot.
I'm waiting for the bombs to drop. See, this is what's going to happen, I think. I think that Trump's going to make this thing closer. Like, I think Hillary Clinton is really going to lose a lot of momentum with all this bullshit happening, and I think Trump's gonna drop some fucking hilarious bombs, and I think it's gonna be a lot closer here pretty soon. Weren't you saying that it was like close in some of the polls earlier in the podcast?
That's like 2 points. Yeah,
that's fucking crazy considering like how big her lead was like what, a few months ago.
Yeah, every poll I've seen it's like 42-44 or 46-44.
Yeah, like she's tanking, dude, and all these like scandals and shit.
Well, and that and Gary Johnson is rising. I mean, his numbers are double what they were a month ago. You know what I mean? So.
Yeah, when people actually find out who that guy is, like, he'll get more popular. It's just that people don't fucking know.
Right. Yep.
All right, man. Well, I don't want to keep you too long. I don't want to get into something considering you've got to go here in 10 minutes. But, yeah, it was a good show.
Yeah,
and I've definitely got some topics for next week, too. We didn't answer the comment. Do you want to do that or no?
Yeah, we can do that real quick. Okay. I don't think there was a lot of, like...
Yeah, the last podcast was a little bit awkward because I didn't want to, like, throw too much mud considering Hodded was on here and I didn't want
to... Did he say anything to you about it after the fact?
No, he didn't. But I was just trying to be courteous to him to not shit on some... Like, because I realize if he's on a podcast and I shit on... Like, he's friends with Phantom Lord, for example, like... I realize if he's on a podcast and I'm shitting on Phantom Lord, even if he isn't shitting on Phantom Lord, it kind of makes him like look bad kind of for associating with me.
Right.
So, yeah, I just wanted to be courteous in that regard because I know he cares more than someone like Asmongold. Like, Asmongold wouldn't give a fuck.
Right. So, I think Asmongold has been my favorite so far.
Yeah, he's good.
Let's see. People shitting on you about shitting on me. And they're like, I wonder who the next podcast host is going to be. It'd be somebody named, like, Brontane. We need to get Dontane back for an episode.
Yeah, I haven't checked on his Twitter. I wonder if he's still in the hospital.
Jewback, you should make your car dealership a Pokestop and set up some lures. It's your duty.
I would do that, but like a car dealership is not the same as like another business. Like foot traffic isn't gonna, it's not the same as like a pizza shop where like if you have foot traffic, there's a really good chance you're gonna sell a lot of pizzas right. with more
you're
foot
not,
traffic.
You're not gonna sell a car to fucking
yeah. You're not gonna get like, oh shit, walking by Harvey's. Oh, I just realized my car's got a dent in the side of it. Gonna bring it on back.
Right. Especially, you're not going to sell a Buick to anyone who plays Pokemon. Because anybody
Dude, the new
that
Buicks
buys a Buick,
are badass, bro. Don't talk shit about Buicks. They're fucking nice.
When's the last time you sold a Buick to somebody that wasn't 40 or over?
This week? Nope, Dude, have you seen the new Buicks? Dude, yeah. The new Buicks are cool as shit.
Did they sign Matthew McConaughey to be like...
I love Buicks.
He's like, no, nobody paid me to do it. I just liked it. Anyway, I vividly remember CSGO coming out, and all my friends hated it. Counter-Strike players are like that, though. We just hate it even when the slightest thing gets changed in the game. Took 2 years for the game to change off, take off, blah, blah, blah. I feel like I need to confess I started playing it again only because skins were a thing. All right.
That's the new Buick.
Eh.
Definitely not an old person car.
No, but it's like a, yeah, I wouldn't buy that. How much is that thing, like 40?
No, it's like 32.
Right, with fucking no AC and like fucking
no.
Crank windows. All right, let's see. I think everybody across the board decided my pit bottle idea was retarded, which is fine. How's it going in Overwatch? I thought you were going to try hard, and you're like, I have a pro team that wanted me to play, but they play too much.
Yeah, that shit. That was so awkward. They're like, yeah, we looked at your gameplay footage. We think you're really good. Do you think you could commit to like a 5 to 6 hour practice period per day? And I was like, no. What about, like, wait.
Are they going to pay you?
No.
Well, why
dude,
the fuck would you
dude,
do that?
Esports... Nobody gets paid in esports except for the top guys.
Why the fuck would you do it then?
Like, because I see why they like people want they want to try and be the top team. They want to try and they're going for it, you know. But yeah. I'm not. I'm a fucking normal guy with a normal job. I can't commit to that.
Right.
Maybe if I was still doing YouTube full time and Twitch full time, then yeah, I would be like all for it. But. No, they're legit. They were legit. I think it's Wise something.
The Hotted song is so funny. The best was from Wreckful Stream where the chat spams Hotted Please and they listen to the song. I can't find the vid, but it's somewhere on his channel. Okay.
Yeah, Wise Frag were the people that tried to recruit me. They're pretty legit.
A lot of people, I think, on the listen to the show think I smoke a lot of pot. This guy's like... I'll hit the blunt with you, dope. I think about shit like that all the time when I was talking about like the thinking in the languages. This other guy said that he thought it was interesting. So fuck off just because you don't think it's interesting. Some people do. Somebody does somewhere. I actually don't smoke a lot of weed.
Do you regularly smoke? Like
no.
Every like once no. every 3 months, for example.
No.
Oh, so it's one of those things where like you haven't done in years.
I don't know about yours, but I definitely don't regularly do it.
Oh, okay. Nah, I was just curious.
I used to grow weed, though, for fun.
For fun?
For fun, dude. It's. I love the smell of
it. Are you worried the NSA is going to be watching?
No. I mean, I never sold it.
Just for fun.
I didn't sell it. I just grew it for fun.
You didn't smoke it?
Me and my roommate actually had it. We rented a house in Norfolk. He had some really big plants, and he bought, like, some lights for the closet and all kinds of shit. And he had to go on a trip, and I didn't really care too much about his plants at the time, but he, like, wanted me to take care of them, and he wanted me to, like, water them, and he, like, had this, like, distilled, like, perfect water, but he, like, ran out of it, and he, like, wanted me to go buy some and, like, feed the plants, and I'm like, fuck that, and I just filled them up with, like, the chlorinated bathtub water.
Oh, my God, I bet those things fucking died instantly.
Oh, yeah, they died pretty quick. It's really fucking mad.
But that's a lot of money.
I don't know, man. I just fucking watered them. It's just water. What do you got? He's like, you can't give them fucking bathtub water. And I'm like, well, all right.
You didn't even use a Brita, bro.
Noted. Damn, your voice got deep. Just watched a video of yours from 5 years ago.
He's talking about me or you?
You.
Yeah.
I don't have a video from 5 years ago. Yeah, I just put my first fucking content video up on YouTube.
I'm gonna look like I look so much fucking different. Like when I actually do that, like before and after video. Like if you go and look, like my shit's coming together. Yeah,
but you also like when did you start doing YouTube? When you were like 15?
Yeah, and I was a late bloomer. I was like exactly. I was like a foot shorter.
Exactly. So like you literally have grown up via your videos on the internet.
Somebody sent me a picture on my Facebook that is like so cringe. Let me try and find it. It's just like a random screen cap of me from like way back in the day.
Should have asked Hodded about the Skechers story.
That sounds pretty entertaining, but unfortunately I did not.
Whole thing about being politically correct as a streamer must suck. That's why I like Zyback, because it's upfront shit, real talk, hang out, things aren't true in opinion. Scary how censoring yourself and immune on things always sways people the wrong way and gives more power to the shit that should not be pissing people off. Yeah, to some extent. You can't, like... I don't think you can be a public personality and just literally say whatever the fuck you want. Like, I guess you can, but... I don't
know. Here's the cringe image of me.
Yeah. That will never get... You should never show that to anyone. Wow.
It's fucking next level, bro.
What's that fucking wallpaper? Is that like...
That's me in my old room. When I used to live in my parents' house when I was like 15.
Wow.
That wallpaper is still there.
I bet
it
is.
That's the wallpaper that I had when I was a kid that never got changed.
Yeah. Hotted didn't want to sound rude, but honestly, the Pet Battle Go idea was just like Zyback said, fucking retarded. No one would play it if it's exactly like Pokemon Go. Eh, maybe. I would play it because I don't play Pokemon Go. I think Pokemon Go is fucking stupid as fuck. My wife loves it.
It's not. Just don't like it. It's not for us.
There's no gameplay.
It's not an actual. It's not about the gameplay though.
Right. I guess
it's about the social craziness.
I don't need a
fucking
thing on my phone to make me go out into the world and say hi to somebody.
Yeah. Well, I think it's a fucking genius.
Yeah. Oh, it is. Yes, it is. I'm not gonna say that it's not a genius product. I just don't. I think it's stupid. Like in and of itself. Like I don't think it's dumb that it for the company that fucking made it, obviously, or the publisher. But anyway.
I think it's funny how people are like cheating the Pokemon Go system. They're like taping their phones to like little trains, like the little toy train sets. People are buying toy train sets and putting and like taping their phones to them so they can level up their Pokemon faster because it simulates walking. And people are like putting their phones and taping their phones to their ceiling fans and shit.
It's so
funny, man.
What is the most embarrassing thing you enjoy? For example, I really like collecting stupid Disney Infinity characters for desk clutter. Also, Hodded seemed nice, but he's really out of his element. What is the most embarrassing thing you enjoy?
I'm sure I've got something. Like, I'm thinking about buying a lightsaber. That's pretty embarrassing.
Really?
Like a fucking... If you look at this website, Ultra Sabers, they're like... legit lightsabers. Let me find it. Sabers. I'm thinking about buying one of these just because they're cool as shit. They are highly, like, very well produced lightsabers that have like metal hilts and the blade is made out of like high quality plastic and you can actually swing at it shit and it doesn't break, but they're fucking expensive. This is like the ultimate waste of money. Like, there's no reason why anyone should have one of these, but they're just cool as fuck.
It's a tube, right? It's a tube that actually lights up.
Yeah, no, and the lighting they use is like really high quality and they look cool as fuck. I'm thinking about getting one.
How much are they?
They're fucking hundreds of dollars.
Wow.
The entry-level ones are not that expensive. Like, to get an entry-level one, it's, like, about $100. But to get it with sound, like, to get it to where, like, when you swing it, it goes... And, like, these things have soundboards in them, and they're, like, really high-quality sound. And It's actually like a fucking legit lightsaber from the movies. It's cool. Obviously, it doesn't cut shit, but like
the movies that you've not even seen in their entirety. Yeah, I mean, yeah. The only thing that you know, I don't know. Like, it's still like a plastic tube that lights up. Like, what they need to be able to do for me to impress me on a lightsaber is to actually figure out a way to have like a light beam that only goes what 4 feet, 5 feet.
And they have to like change the laws of physics somehow. Yep. Like, figure out how to stop light.
Yep. Exactly. Let's see.
That's pretty embarrassing that I'm actually thinking about. And this is coming from a guy that's like very frugal. Like, I pride myself on being very smart with my money, and I'm highly considering buying one of these things.
Yeah, who cares? It's your money. Enjoy triggering my wife. And actually, one way that I trigger her a lot is for literally no reason, I pee in bottles all the time.
Yeah, that's another autistic thing. That's just another thing to add to the list.
I just enjoy peeing in bottles.
Dude, that's not normal. Like, that's just another thing you add to the list of autistic shit. Like, I thought you were going to say, like, some, like, little prank, like, that actually is, like, that's not funny. That's just, like, fucking.
No, it's funny how mad she gets. She's like, God damn it, you're 10 foot away from the fucking bathroom. That's just dude, like
it's just fucking weird, man. That's not.
It's funny because she gets
like I thought you were gonna be. I thought you were saying like fuck with your wife. Like I don't know, these like little pranks and shit. Not like
it's a prank.
Sometimes I just shit in the shower.
No, I don't do that. A bottle thing because it's self-contained. It's not whatever. It's just funny because it pisses her off so bad. That's why I continue to do it.
Your fucking daughter is growing up in a very weird environment.
Yeah, whatever. She'll be fine.
Like, I'm thinking about, like, my childhood, and I've never had my dad, like, pull over and shit outside a gas station. Like, things like that.
Sorry.
I mean, your daughter's, what, not even a year old?
No.
Like, she's already gone through the gambit of interesting shit that I've never seen.
Yeah.
Like, I never saw my dad pissing in bottles.
Well, I mean, she's, yeah, right.
Again, what, you think I'm lying about? Yeah, right. Never saw that.
No, I'm just saying, like, I mean, I don't fucking, like, whip my dick out in front of my kid and piss in a bottle. Like this. But yes, she's going to have a very weird upbringing. Let's see.
She's going to be, like, that awkward kid at school where, like she'll talk about her home life and people are going to be like, wait, what? You know what I'm talking about? Like, where, like people, like a kid in class will say something and be like, wait, what the fuck did he just say? Like, right. One kid, like, said his parents, like, walked around naked all the time, and everybody was like, what? It's like one of those weird, yeah.
Yeah, probably. That was pretty much it in the comments. She's mad, though. I have to actually go, because she's like, baby's crying, and I'm hungry, and blah, blah. So, I gotta go take care of the family situation.
All right. You want to see this lightsaber real quick?
Hi, everybody.
I just saw it.
This is not the video. Never mind. Never mind. We're done.
What? What are you talking about? I just saw it.
I thought I found the video, but I didn't.
Okay.
All right. So, I guess that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed Hive Mind number 30. Let me look at it. Shit, what was this? 35? 36? 36. Hope you guys enjoyed Hive Mind 36. We'll see you again next week. Check us out on YouTube, SoundCloud, iTunes, Google Play, whatever. Follow us on Twitter. And we'll see you again next week. Have a good one.
Later.